is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states, it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
As of today, the average cost of a pack of cigarettes has gone up to 2 hand jobs and a stick of beef jerky. For more, we go now to Onion News Network prison economics expert Hal Rogan.
The prison economy runs on cigarettes. They're involved in every economic transaction at some stage, from contract killings to naked woman picture acquisition.
Right.
That's why we've got shampoo at 6 batteries. We've got tattoos at 50 commissary stamps.
Now, for what it's really like out there in the market, let's check in with major cigarette trader Big Dap Ramirez. Big Dap, nice to see you again.
Thanks, Rick. Good to see you. What's happening, Hal?
How's it going, Big Dap?
Now, it's obviously a boom time for cigarettes. Right now.
I am getting a lot of hand jobs.
But with prices this high, analysis shows you're going to be seeing a drop-off in real sales soon as consumers turn to smoking grass fajos.
Look, we've been through this before. The market teaches us not to panic. Mm. But if I learn anything in this game, it's that a wife or girlfriend will pass off a few decks in the boneyard. Supply will normalize, and we'll see cigarettes returning to a single hand job or less.
Let's Big Dap, best of luck to you. We'll keep checking in on the story with Hal throughout the day.
Thanks, Rick.
Moving on to some happier news. In Atlanta today, two snitches were beaten to death.
This is the Onion News Network.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You dial toll-free. Bring up anything you want. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online at freetalklive.com, where if you've got some Bitcoin you'd like to share with us, you can do that through our Bitcoin tip jar over at bitcoin.freetalklive.com. You'll find our Bitcoin address there, as well as some links that'll help you get Bitcoin, like expresscoin.com, or learn more about Bitcoin from weusecoins.com. Expresscoin, though, is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrency of choice. There's Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, all available at expresscoin.com. They're fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive, and they're a licensed money services business. You can get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, or wire transfer, and just go to expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the United States or Canada, they can help you. Expresscoin.com. Use coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live, and you'll get up to $40 worth of your preferred cryptocurrency with no fee at all. But if you've got more than $40 worth, then it's a really great fee. I don't think you're going to find a better price anywhere online. At least I haven't seen it. ExpressCoin.com. Go get your favorite cryptocurrency, and don't forget code FTL. Let's go to Troy in northern Minnesota. Troy, you're on Free Talk Live, listening to WNMT.
Hey, how are you guys doing today?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
Well, you know, I really like you guys' program and all that, but I'm just not into all this freewheeling, dope-smoking stuff. I just don't think it's a good thing. I think everything has a downside to it. I've been in the construction business now for 40 years. I've seen what it does to people. It slows their motor skills down as far as their movements. They seem to not be able to think as clear when it comes to certain things. I totally disagree. It's like alcohol. Everything has a downside to it. But all people want to preach about is the good things, you know?
Yeah, I think that happens. I'd agree with you that has occurred with marijuana, and it's probably because it's illegal and people want it to be legal. So what they're doing is they're playing up the good sides, and they're not playing up the bad side.
Well, yeah, but just because you don't like something, or that you can see some of the negative sides of it, or that you think that the use of it is deleterious or bad, doesn't mean that you should make a problem worse by throwing somebody in a jail cell, right?
No, not at all. You need to get them freaking help when you need to get them.
Well,
you
know? I mean,
think about it this way. No, just wait a second here. Now, okay. Listen to this. What more better would the government like to do is to legalize all the drugs, just like what you were saying, you can put anything and everything in your own body. What benefit would that have with our government? You'd have a drugged-up, lazy society that didn't give a damn about nothing.
I got news for you, man. That's already happening. I can already put whatever I want in my own body. I mean, the government's never stopped me from taking any of the drugs I've ever taken in my life. It's just that, you know, if I happen to get caught with one of them on my person, then I'll go to prison and they'll ruin my life. So, I mean, you can argue against the use of drugs. That's fine. You can try to persuade people to not use them. You can show them other options for, you know, things to do with their free time or whatever. But when you get to the point of wanting to either put someone in a jail cell, which you disagreed with, and thank you for that. I'm glad you don't want to put someone in a jail cell, or force them into treatment.
Like, take these people. I mean, it's like it's a joke. You know, you got a DUI, and you're on your fifth DUI. You get a slap on the wrist. You get sent out.
Well,
you know what?
Most places, I don't know about Minnesota, but in most places, it's not a slap on the wrist on DUI number 5.
It's not a slap on the wrist in DUI number 1.
In a lot of places. Yeah, that's true. But look, I mean, to force someone into treatment is also something I disagree with, because you can't take somebody who's not ready to quit and put them into a system that is designed to help them quit. And it also hurts the people who are ready to quit. If you go to some sort of a help group, whether it's Narcotics Anonymous or Alcoholics Anonymous, and that group is littered with people who are there on a court order who really don't, you know, they're not interested in actually quitting, then that actually harms the people who are there for the legitimate reason of they actually are ready to quit. You know, they've hit rock bottom, Troy, and they're ready to do something about it. So forcing people into treatment is also not effective. And really, ultimately, what these forced treatment programs do is they're like, you know, sort of like welfare for these treatment centers where the government courts. Say what?
I agree 100% with you.
Okay,
good. It's just like what's going on up in Denver. You know, I mean, look what's going on up there with the social service programs up there, because you've had such an influx of people coming into the area because they legalized it. Whatever. I don't care if they legalize it. But look what happens to the area as far as their social programs, the welfare system, health insurance, Medicaid, Medicare. I mean, now it's being maxed. So they need to take some of that money then and distribute it back into those programs.
Well, they should just eliminate the program.
They've got $60 million. They made so much money, Troy, that they're actually refunding to taxpayers. So that's working out.
Know,
let me ask you this, though, Troy. Here's a question for you.
I guarantee you one thing. I would love, I mean, I got a farm. And I told my boys, I said, if they legalize it here in Minnesota, I'm growing me a cash crop instead of corn and soybeans.
It's the largest cash crop in the world. You can make the, you know, as far as nationally. But let me ask you this: would you be willing to institute a program that has been shown in both Portugal and the Netherlands to have been successful in causing people to use people generally to use drugs less?
Oh, 100%.
Great. That program will call decriminalization of drugs, because when they decriminalize drugs in Portugal and in Amsterdam, they saw a decrease not only of young people, but people generally using drugs. It also worked in California when they, because they've had that medical marijuana out there that basically anybody can get who goes to a, I don't know, a yoga studio and says, I got a back pain. And in that period of time, they've actually seen violent crime and nonviolent crime decrease along with young people's use of drugs.
You know, I kind of look at it as like smoking cigarettes with kids. But now, granted, guys, I've never even smoked a joint in my life. I don't take any drugs. And I barely drink at all. You know, and I kind of look at it this way. What happens when you get mad at your parents, you know, or when, the establishment is telling you not to do something? Hell, we went out and started smoking, started drinking.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Because that's what they told us not to do. The area that I grew up out west, I mean, I grew up in the mountains in Wyoming. You didn't have weed. You know, so, I mean, we took alcohol and smoking and chewing. But that's what we were preached at. You don't do that. So the more people get preached at not to do something, what are the kids going to do? You know? And I guess my other big gripe about this is that, and you guys have to admit this, this stuff that's coming into this country, this weed, there's no control over it because you don't know what's been put on it.
Well, that's true. And the reason why there's no control is because it's part of the black market, right? So because it's been made illegal...
Exactly.
It's being handled by drug cartels. It's being handled by people who are willing to defend their turf with violence. You know, you don't see Budweiser going and blowing up, I don't know, do they even own Jim Beam? I don't know who owns who. But, you know, you don't see Budweiser going and blowing up Coors, for instance. You know, they're not shooting, their distributors are not shooting one another in the streets. So we don't have a problem. I mean, the worst thing that'll happen is a truck will crash and some beer will spill into the street, right? I mean, that's about as bad as it gets now.
Exactly.
It's not like it was during Prohibition, at least during alcohol prohibition. So it sounds to me, Troy, like we're actually on the same page as far as like you can see the value in decriminalizing or legalizing. It's just that what I'm hearing from you is that you're concerned with maybe the way things are being talked about, that that you'd like to hear a more balanced discussion on the effects of these drugs.
I mean, smoking cigarettes gives you cancer, but smoking weed is all herbal and natural.
Well, there's actually evidence that shows that smoking weed might actually help prevent cancer or even reduce cancer, but that's another story. Thanks, Troy, for the call tonight. I appreciate it. It's an interesting world and one worth looking into, and thank you again. And you never know, you know, it might help you someday. You come down with some sort of horrible malady.
If you've got cancer, the worst, weed's certainly not the worst thing that's going to happen to you.
Yeah, there's more coming up here in moments. Of course, you can share your thoughts with us. It's Free Talk Live.
As if chlorine in our water weren't bad enough, now they're adding ammonia?
It's true. Some municipalities are now adding ammonia plus chlorine to your water supply. It's a disinfectant called chloramine. But with a trusted Big Berkey water filter, you can keep chloramine out of your water. New NSF EPA certified lab tests show EPA Berkey water filters remove chloramines, pharmaceuticals, BPA, pesticides, bacteria and viruses, all forms of fluoride, and much more. Big Berkey water filters are the original and most trusted on the market. The gold standard in water purification. And our filters last for years at less than 2 cents per gallon. Big Berkey, the one that's powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. Get your Big Berkey today. Call 1-877-99-BERKEY or click BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. That's 1-877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippie! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Woo! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And don't forget, you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. Lots of features are waiting for you there on that site. They're all totally free, unlike a lot of those talk show hosts who want to charge you for accessing their sites. Once again, freetalklive.com.
FortGault.com. What Fort Gault is a kind of like a condominium, maybe a resort for liberty-oriented folks down in southern Chile. And so what they're doing is they're building a complex. It's going to be created by Bensonwood, which is a high-end architecture organization, actually here in New Hampshire.
Oh, so, wow.
You didn't know that?
Nope.
Nope. There you go. Bensonwood's a big deal. So what they're doing is they're going to build really ultra small units in there, potentially small units. They let you have any size you want, but as small as 4 feet by 11 feet. And I think those are going to price at somewhere around $11,000. So that's a pretty, I mean, pretty much anybody can afford that. And now there's going to be a lot of communal spaces, a makerspace full of tools, a restaurant where people can hang out, lots of hangout spaces, workspaces, things like that. And the idea is to create this sort of liberty enclave down in Chile. And it bears mentioning that Chile, of course, is having its summer when it's winter down here. So it's obviously you could have an opportunity to escape the cold here in the United States. It's going to be affordable for those looking to establish a little home base outside the country. Go check them out. FortGault.com. Their project is interesting, and I'd love to see it get off the ground just to see what would happen. FortGault.com.
All right, our toll-free number again, 855-450-FREE. So it was. I thought that last call that we had was interesting, you know, because it sort of started out like there was some conflict there, and then we ended up finding all these points of agreement. The gentleman worked in construction, and, you know, he feels like he's seen some of what he considers to be the deleterious effects of cannabis. And I, you know, would not recommend using cannabis while on a construction site.
Yeah, let's not move heavy equipment around while stoned.
Yeah, it just
seems
doesn't
like a bad idea.
I mean, I'm an advocate of cannabis use, but I would not go
not that much of an advocate of, yeah.
But I can tell you, you know, I've known plenty of construction guys, and I know it's certainly not uncommon for construction guys to be high.
Are you saying construction guys might smoke pot?
Oh boy, do they. Not only do they smoke pot, but they'll drink on the job as well. So it's actually really amazing that anything actually does get built to spec. And I mean, considering how common it is for construction people to be using various different mind and mood altering substances while actually on the job, it's pretty impressive that they managed to get it done as effectively as they do. But you know, we ended up coming to all these points of agreement. Like, well, you know, he agreed that people should not be locked up for using cannabis, and that even though he supports treatment, he also agreed that he didn't support forced treatment. So a lot of times when people throw out treatment as an option, they are talking about forcing users into a treatment system, which really isn't that much better than jail. I'll maybe give it to you that it's a little bit better than jail, but it's not that much better, because what makes it a little bit better is that, well, you're not in a jail cell during that time frame. But,
sure.
But it's also not good because it's really not helpful for people to force them into something that they're not ready for. But I realize that some people might hear me say that and say, well, you don't want to help people. Well, I'm fine with helping people, but they have to want it. They have to be ready for it.
You can't help somebody who doesn't want help when it comes to treatment.
Right.
All you're doing is dragging it down for everybody else.
Absolutely.
The Alcoholics Anonymous program, and I may have some problems with it, and Narcotics Anonymous is the same way.
Right.
They have one line that I certainly agree with, is the only requirement for membership is a desire to stop using.
Mm-hmm.
And that means, you know, conversely, if you do not have a desire to stop using, you are not qualified for membership.
Yeah, you don't
belong.
You
should not be there. These people are struggling every minute and every day not to use, and you're there not committed to not using? Get out.
It can be difficult to watch someone that you love, whether they be a family member, a friend, or a coworker, whoever, to watch somebody that you care about struggle with drug addiction or alcohol addiction. Again, alcohol is a drug. But to watch them struggle with that, to reach out to them and to let them know that you care and to let them know that, you know, you're willing to help them when they're ready for that help. But, you know, to leave it there, to be willing to just stop at that point, to not go further and, you know, force them into some sort of a program. I can understand how that could be frustrating, because you ultimately, you know, you want what's best for that person, and you know what's best. You know that what's best for them is to stop smoking meth or whatever it is that their problem is. But they're not there yet. You know, they haven't, even though it may seem to you like they're at rock bottom, to them, maybe they're not. And it can be difficult to watch someone struggle, to watch somebody hurt themselves over time, to watch them lose a job, to watch them lose a loved one, you know, have their wife or husband divorce them, or girlfriend or boyfriend break up with them, and, you know, have their kids taken from them. And I mean, that's got to be hard to go through as someone who cares about that person.
Sure.
But you can't express how much you care, I don't think, at least. And if you disagree, feel free to call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. I don't think that forcing them into some sort of a treatment program is an expression of how you care for that person. I think that that's the wrong thing to do. It's only going to create resentment towards you as the person who put them in that position.
Right. Well, you can, if you are close to somebody who has a drug problem, whatever that drug problem might be, you can take all kinds of steps to help that person along their way. So, for instance, you can disallow them from living in your home
okay.
when they do drugs. You can refuse to give them money to do drugs. You can
yep.
do a whole bunch of different things. These are just a couple of ideas. Don't allow them to drive your car if they're going to have drugs.
Yeah, sure.
And or have, at all, if they're going to have used drugs. If they've used drugs in the last week, don't allow them to drive your car. Whatever it is, you state it to them, so they're clear as to what it is and why it is, and then you follow through. You know, do the tough love.
Tough
thing.
Love, yeah.
It's not that big of a deal.
Tough love without force.
You have no obligation to help somebody use mind-altering substances. You, as their parent, as their boyfriend or their girlfriend or whatever it is that you are, you have no obligation to them. Your obligation is to yourself and what your values are.
Mm-hmm.
And if those are what your values are, stick with them, because you're not helping anybody else. But at the same time, when you're trying to force somebody, it's not going to work.
Well, yeah. I mean, using force usually has unintended consequences, and we've seen it crystal clear on the national level or on the state or local level with the governments of the world and our local governments. You know, when they use force, we see how that backfires. We see how the war on drugs has backfired, that, you know, they thought they could somehow stop people from using drugs by threatening them, by putting them in cages. But ultimately, that doesn't work. It just makes their lives that much worse. And a lot of people are using drugs because they want to escape from a bad life or from what they perceive of as a bad life. A lot of people, you know, we've seen studies about this. Remember the study, which was really shocking to me even, you know, and I'm not unfamiliar with the sort of the underground drug world, that the study of the heroin and crack and meth addicts who were brought into a hospital environment and given the choice between a nice, fresh, pure rock of crack cocaine every day in the morning or whenever, and or a $20 bill. Now, of course, the trick was they had to wait on the $20 bill. If they said yes to the money, they would collect it 3 weeks later after this long-term study was done. So they were literally in that hospital for 3 weeks. Going through this study.
What this study, and it's been replicated too. Mm-hmm. There's not just one study. What this study showed is there actually is no such thing as drug addiction. What there is desperate people.
Yeah, there are people with choices and, you know, really tough lives who feel like these drugs are an escape from those lives. And when they see that there is a light at the end of the tunnel, when they have what they perceive of as a better option, they'll choose that better option. I mean, these were what seemed like hopeless addicts that they brought into this study.
Sure.
And they found that when it was like $5, it wasn't, they really didn't go for the $5 right. that much. But when it was $20, they picked the $20 more often than not. And they stuck with
sometimes
the
$20
money.
Wouldn't even be given until after the program was
over.
It
would never be given until after the program was
never
over.
Never after? Okay.
Until 3 weeks later. And so we'll come back with more here. 855-450-FREE. People respond to incentives. It's Free Talk Live.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
How fast are new Allegra gel caps?
I didn't know you got a cat fast.
How strong are new Allegra gel caps?
10 more logs to go strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gives you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms in just 1 hour. 2 times faster than Claritin and stays strong for 24 hours.
It's relief when the pollen's off the charts strong, even in the convertible.
New Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster. Nothing's stronger. Guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates. 1-800-425-4610.
Based on actual cases, results may vary. Not a solicitation for legal services.
Uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies. That's what the readers of FreedomsPhoenix.com get every day. FreedomsPhoenix.com constantly providing the information, the real news about government policies, and the real relationship we all have with the coercive government. The real condition of the economy, innovations in technology, breakthroughs in energy, health, and computer science. Learn the truth well before it's admitted to in the lamestream media. The corporate media, nothing more than distributors of government propaganda, but now there's an alternative. freedomsphoenix.com. Constant news updates on the issues that affect your life in the most important ways. With liberty and property under constant attack, freedomsphoenix.com provides the understanding behind the propaganda, and it encourages the participation of its readers. Go to freedomsphoenix.com. That's freedoms with an S, phoenix.com. freedomsphoenix.com. The revolution between the ears has already happened.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
I love my magic mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my magic mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My magic mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. Mymagicmud.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. We invite you here to dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online at freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features that we have waiting for you there. Once again, freetalklive.com. If you like the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, then we'd like you to shop with us by going to shop.freetalklive.com. You're actually shopping on Amazon, but you're entering through our affiliate link, so Free Talk Live gets a cut of the purchase. You're paying the same great Amazon prices with the same great, you know, free Super Saver shipping or Amazon Prime deals. It's just that you're entering through our affiliate link, so Free Talk Live gets a cut of their profits. So go to shop.freetalklive.com. You'll find links there for Amazon US, Amazon Canada, and Amazon UK. And again, it's easy, and it makes a big difference for us when you do it that way. So please go to shop.freetalklive.com. Virgil Vaduva, who we had on the show earlier this week, has posted to his Facebook page about the experience that he had in court today in Xenia, Ohio. You may recall that Virgil was arrested recently for a violation of the panhandling ordinance there in town, or at least what was an apparent violation of the panhandling ordinance. As he'll make clear, he actually didn't violate the text of the ordinance, but that didn't prevent the jury from finding him guilty today. So let me share the story. By the way, he doesn't live in Xenia. He lives about probably 15 minutes away. He had heard about this panhandling ordinance, and he'd also heard that panhandling ordinances had been overturned in other places. I remember, Mark, when you and I went down to Florida. Actually, I think when I went down without you once, I noticed that there were a lot more people on the streets asking for money, and that's because the ACLU had won a case that essentially invalidated any panhandling ordinances across the entirety of the state of Florida. So this is sort of a trend that has been happening, but apparently Xenia hasn't caught wind of it yet. And so now Virgil has decided to take this up as an issue and committed a little bit of civil disobedience. It was not his first arrest, but I think his second. He's also been arrested for being a photographer at a protest at a local mall in the area as well.
Yeah, it sounds like the cops there locally are still trying to figure this out. All these people doing these protests and stuff.
Oh, they figured it out. They arrest people they don't like and then charge them with a bunch of nonsense. Yeah. They've got it figured out pretty
good. It didn't really work out that well for them here in Keene, and probably over time, if they get enough pressure, they'll stop up there too.
Virgil writes, "So I finally made it in front of a computer to post an update about the trial from this morning. Unfortunately, I mistakenly started the Bambuser stream in private, so no one got to watch it live. But the recording is here with a really sucky soundtrack," and he links to it. "The entire thing," I hope there was a better camera there. We need to find out about that. "The entire thing lasted a bit over an hour, and then it took the jury about 20 minutes to find me guilty of panhandling, in spite of their law defining panhandling as asking for money only for personal use." Now, didn't he tell us, and he says that's not what he was doing. Didn't he tell us he was doing it for charity or something?
It's true. It's given away.
Right. So by definition of the law itself, of the ordinance text defining panhandling, this wasn't actually panhandling.
What does the jury care? They're a bunch of mouth-breathing sycophants. They find the oldest, dumbest, and most compliant, and they put them on a jury.
Well, doesn't this also show that it's not a nation of laws, right? This is a nation of men. Even in this case, the men and women on the jury who arbitrarily decided that this guy should be convicted of panhandling when the law itself makes it clear that it's not actually panhandling. I mean, if the law doesn't fit, they're not supposed to convict this person. But yet they did anyway. Sort of like they did with...
They told him he couldn't talk about the Constitution in the courtroom,
that's true.
Too.
It's sort of like the case of the Bartholomew brothers out in California who were convicted of crimes that did not actually, they were not found guilty of at a trial.
It's like the opposite of jury nullification.
Yeah, it's like jury convict. I don't know what you call that. What the hell do you call
finding
that?
Finding people guilty of crimes they didn't commit, obviously, of which there is no evidence that they committed.
So he says it's a good outcome. It's a good outcome. And his, by the way, sentencing is going to be on Tuesday.
Well, I mean, the outcome is terrible for the taxpayers of Xenia because they're going to be paying to take this thing all the way to federal court. These idiots on the first in the prosecutor's office, the police, the prosecutors, and now the jury, they all just racked up a giant tax bill for Xenia, Ohio. Good going, folks. You had an opportunity to support free speech and stop some silly, silly lawsuit from going through. That's already been decided, by the way. The case law on this is clear.
Yeah.
This is freedom of speech. It's happening all across the country, and you just cost yourself probably hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of dollars.
So he says this is the outcome he was expecting, as it sets the stage for the next step, which is an appeal and then a federal lawsuit against the city of Xenia for violating people's civil rights.
A federal lawsuit that he's going to win and probably get some kind of ruling on.
Hopefully he'll get some money out of it, too.
That's what I mean.
That'll be nice to help him move to New Hampshire with. That's the long game, he says, for this, and the short-term consequences are not that important. Which, by the way, the short-term consequences, he's told us, could be 30 days in jail. Now, this sounds like it's his first conviction, so, the judge may not sentence him to jail on this. We'll find out more about that next week, but it's possible. You know, maybe this judge will want to send a message to all those panhandlers out there or to anyone who would dare to involve themselves in civil disobedience. It's certainly possible that that could happen. Anyway, throughout the trial, the judge, he says, prohibited me from bringing up my First Amendment rights and repeatedly denied my motions to reconsider, allowing me to bring up the constitutionality of this law. At one point, the prosecutor told the jury that the state has the right to regulate speech, at which point the entire gallery of people that came to support me burst into uncontrollable laughter. The judge threatened them with getting kicked out of the courtroom. The jury pool was stacked with government employees, one cop, a woman who stated on the record she is very pro-police, and a guy who had a bunch of cop relatives. The outcome is not a surprise at all. Dio Odalecki got to follow some of the jurors out of the courthouse and tried to ask them some questions. One black juror said, "I broke the law and therefore I need punishment," when Dio pointed out to him that slavery used to be legal, he answered, "That was in the past."
Right. All the laws now are good.
I have mixed emotions about this, writes Virgil. On one hand, I was hoping to find some shred of humanity and justice in the hearts of jurors, which would have been a win for the jury process, but clearly that's not the case, as the state has brainwashed people into blindly obeying instructions from people in robes and completely forego the morality and ethics of justice. On the other hand, it's a win because it moves my original plan forward, which was always to give Xenia a taste of justice in the federal courts. Thanks to everyone who showed up to support me, I'm honored to count you among my friends. So I will put a link to his Bamboozer video, which, again, he says the soundtrack's not so great. I haven't actually sampled it myself, so I can't speak as to whether or not it's even listenable. But I'm really hoping that there was somebody with an actual proper camera recording this hearing. I think the more that we can get this kind of stuff out there, the better off everybody is, because a lot of people are afraid of court. A lot of people are intimidated by this system and the process and showing what it's really like, I think, you know, and not like, you know, Judge Judy, but what
it's
really like.
Why wouldn't they be intimidated in this circumstance, yeah, though? I mean, this guy went in front of a jury of his supposed peers in this case, he was peerless, but that's my opinion. He went in front of a jury of his peers. He presented the evidence that he did not commit the crime, even if the crime was bad. Then he talked about how they can nullify the crime, right?
No, he was not allowed to do that.
Unable to even mention the Constitution, they found him guilty.
Let's go to Steve. He's in St. George, Utah, listening to KZNU. Hey, Steve.
Hey, a couple of times now I've heard you ask, what is the opposite of jury nullification? I got a good term for you.
Yes.
It's called rubber stamping.
No.
Okay. Yeah, that's not
they
bad.
They just kind of go right along with whatever's being stated. The judge says, find him guilty. Okay.
Whatever you say. Well, let's get out of here. We are hungry.
Yeah. That's called rubber stamping in my book. Yep.
Likely this is the case. I mean, if you're on a jury with somebody who says they're very pro-police, and those people are definitely in existence. And somebody who's got relatives that are police officers, you're going to have a heck of a time acquitting this guy. All you can hope to do is hang the jury, and that's going to take forever because the judge is going to send you back. You're going to talk about hours. You're going to sit there and listen to people badger you while they're, but the police are just doing their jobs, and these are laws. It's a nation of laws. Western civilization falls apart.
Sorry about that.
No, go ahead.
Juries are notoriously difficult, but, when you don't have a jury, you've got a judge who's on the payroll of the state.
Yep.
Prosecutor who's on the payroll of the state, the clerk who's on the payroll of the state, the bailiff who's on the payroll of the state, all of these people are on the payroll of the state, and you're the only one that's not. Any question how this is going to turn out?
Yeah.
There's not really much of a question.
Oh. You nailed that one, Steve.
All right.
Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So we will continue to update you as we learn more about Virgil's case and where it goes next, which again is going to be sentencing. And I imagine that if he's sentenced to jail, that he'll have to go ahead and sit in jail while he appeals. We'll find out more, though. It's Free Talk Live. You can take control of the airwaves. Hour 2's coming up.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com. And Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 2 is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, March 26th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.18 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,211 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $252. Antiwar.com reports the Saudi ambassador to the United States has announced that his country has begun military operations against Yemen with an eye towards restoring General Abd Rabu Mansour Hadi as the legitimate government. Reports are that the military action began with airstrikes, which Saudi officials insist are being conducted only by Saudi warplanes and not with coordination from any other country against the Houthi forces. Yemen was heading in the direction of a multi-faction civil war at any rate, with Hadi's forces increasingly confined to the south, the Houthis spanning the north and west, Al-Qaeda in the tribal areas, and the Islamic State and forces of previous dictator Ali Abdullah Saleh both roaming around as well. Now the Saudis are in the mix. Obviously, the Saudis' goal is to install a friendly government, and to that end, they're seeing General Hadi, who was elected in a single candidate vote in 2012, as having at least a little legitimacy. Hadi's resignation and subsequent fleeing into exile, however, are going to make it awfully hard for the Saudis to reassert him as a credible ruler. Hadi had been courting the Saudis as a backer, claiming the Houthis were backed by Saudi Arabia's regional rival, Iran. While there was limited evidence of Iran backing the Houthis before, they almost certainly will at this point, just to counter the Saudi incursion. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports the U.S. House of Representatives on Wednesday approved a massive budget nearing $4 trillion for the coming fiscal year by invoking a rarely used congressional tactic called the Queen of the Hill rule. Republican Party leaders have been trying to come up with a budget that addresses concerns over deepening the deficit and overspending on defense. Lawmakers rejected the first budget proposed by a vote of 105 to 319, but GOP legislators had opted to invoke a little used and little known parliamentary tactic known as the Queen of the Hill rule. The method allowed lawmakers to submit more than one budget proposal and finalize whichever majority-approved version received the most votes. Lawmakers went for the Queen option largely because they expected dissenting opinions among Republicans, which have been abundant since the start of 2015 and which have, according to the Washington Post, handed Democrats a much-needed political boost. The Senate is working on its own budget proposal this week. Both houses of Congress must approve whichever budget is ultimately to be implemented.
You can support FPP Radio by shopping online. Whether you're looking for precious metals, bitcoins, or books, you'll find that and more at shop.fppradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. That's shop.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports the Justice Department's internal watchdog reported that the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms, and Explosives spent about $600,000 on six drones that had so many defects that they were never used for video surveillance as planned and were eventually ditched. The Office of the Inspector General said it was troubled that the ATF spent so much money between September 2011 and September 2012 on drones that were rendered unsuitable. The audit found ATF officials spent about $315,000 on one gas-powered drone that was never used due to multiple technical defects. In other instances, a $90,000 drone was found to be unreliable, and another model had a flight battery time of only 20 minutes, less than half the time the manufacturer claimed. The report did not name the manufacturer of any of the six faulty drones, which were eventually given away to the Naval Crime Investigative Services. After discovering these problems, the ATF suspended its drone program in June 2014, but 1 week later, another unit in the ATF spent $15,000 on five drones. The report did not say whether those drones had any operational problems, but they have since been grounded pending further guidance. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Saying that a few images of displaced refugees would probably do the trick, Americans admitted this week that they could probably be talked into another war. Citizens nationwide told reporters that if they were to see a blurry satellite image of potential nuclear weapons or footage of an evil militant group, they could easily see themselves getting on board with another major military effort.
I'm not saying I'd be gung-ho about it right away, but if they called it something like a concentrated military operation or something other than war at first, I could see myself warming up to the idea. Honestly, just hearing a top official on TV say something like patriotic duty might clinch it.
And in this week's op-ed pages, an area man finds it's just his luck to lose thousands at the blackjack tables every night for the past few weeks. In other news, a senator tries submitting a rejected bill to the Canadian Parliament. What mom would have wanted is evolving over the course of funeral planning. And a new report finds you're actually saving money with a Franklin Skate Center roller rink membership.
This is the Onion News Network.
Sign the verdict form and in. You will have with you in the jury room the...
Oops. I was playing the audio from the trial there. I was watching Virgil Vaduva's Bamboozer, which the audio is actually not as bad as he had said that it was. It's just recorded at a very low volume, so you will have to turn it up if you want to hear it. We were talking about Virgil Vaduva, who is a friend of the show, listener of Free Talk Live. He's come out to visit New Hampshire a number of times with his family and is looking at making a move out here at some point. Hopefully, the legal situations he's gotten himself into in Xenia, Ohio, and surrounding areas recently will not delay their arrival here to New Hampshire, which is one of the risks of getting really excited about doing activism, especially of the civilly disobedient type, is the court system has a way of sort of tying you up and literally tying you down. You know, if you're convicted of something, a lot of cases, you know, there's going to be conditions on you, or even if you, prior to your conviction, rather, you know, certain bail conditions may be very, very restrictive. You may not be allowed to leave the state. For instance, here in New Hampshire, there's a local head shop here in Keene, where we're doing the show from, where the owners have been arrested for selling pipes, apparently, by the federal government. Part of their bail conditions is they can't leave New Hampshire. So it can get a little sticky, a little difficult when you get into the world of civil disobedience. Luckily, Virgil had some folks there backing him up at trial. Somebody was there recording video of it, and I have posted that link to our Facebook, Google Plus. Wait, no, not Google Plus. Our Facebook and Twitter. Something happened with Google Plus. We got disconnected from our Hootsuite, and no one really uses it anyway. So sorry, our three Google Plus users, or yeah, however many there are. I don't even know. I haven't logged in there in forever.
Yeah, they'd be mad if they could sum up the indignation to do something about it.
So anyway, you can go check it out on our Facebook or Twitter. And you can access both of those by going to news.freetalklive.com. Of course, plenty of stuff to talk about. We'll talk with you about whatever's on your mind. And Mark, you and I, we're leaving soon for the Texas Bitcoin Conference. We'll tell you a little bit more about that coming up, which will be very exciting. In other news, there's a cop block agent who has been targeted because of a Facebook post. Felony charge over a Facebook post. Now, you might say to yourself that it would have to be a threatening post. There would have to be some kind of horrible thing that he said on Facebook in order to justify.
Not after I hear this ruling of in the Virgil Vaduva case where the jury finds him guilty of something he didn't, finds him guilty when it's clear he didn't do it.
Yeah, well, this is yet another example of another sort of lone activist out there being targeted by the system to be stamped out. And I'll get into that story from the Pro Libertate blog. William Grigg, of course, does always a great job of researching and reporting on police abuse sort of things. Let's go first, though, to your calls and thoughts. We got Pete in Charleston. Pete, which Charleston are you in tonight?
Do we have Pete? I'm in Charlotte.
Oh, Charlotte. It was misspelled here. I apologize. Go ahead, Pete.
Some questions about Bitcoin. I have some Bitcoin, and I have them in a Bitcoin.info wallet.
Blockchain.info.
Blockchain.info wallet, and I was wondering, I hear all these words about private keys and everything, and I need to protect those, and I don't even know what my private keys are, and I don't know how to access them, and all I do is enter a password and get the two-factor authentication, you know, with my cell phone.
Yep. The
Basically,
and how
the,
am I going to secure these things?
They're secured in the blockchain .info wallet basically already, as long as you don't lose your email password. If you like your email account gets hacked because, you know, your blockchain's attached to it, then, you know, they could, you know, change your password or something like that, and that would be the only
issue,
right?
Well, that's
not
a good answer, Mark. And look, let me explain a little bit about Bitcoin for our listeners who may be new to the technology. So bear with me for a moment, Pete. Bitcoin's a decentralized currency. It's not issued by any government or any bank. Decentralized meaning it's essentially peer-to-peer, sort of like file sharing technology, torrents, things like that, that there are nodes on a network. You know, hundreds of thousands of people around the world create this Bitcoin network, and there's no central authority that's sort of overseeing it. There are a group of programmers who, over time, are improving upon Bitcoin, you know, making it better, upgrading it, if you will. But there's, you know, if the programmers do something that people don't like and they don't accept it, then it's not going to stick. There's a lot of details behind the sort of the technical side of things. But one of the important things to know about how Bitcoin works from a security aspect is that it is a very secure system that, you know, it can't be hacked, but someone could take your private key from you if you don't protect it. And that's kind of what you're asking about, Pete. The way Bitcoin works is when you have a Bitcoin wallet, and blockchain.info is the company you've chosen to hold your wallet for you, essentially. You are essentially trusting them as you would trust a bank to hold your money. Now, in the past, there have been some less than trustworthy companies that have offered to hold wallets. Mark, you and I, in the early days of Bitcoin, what was it called? My Bitcoin Wallet or something like that?
MyBitcoinWallet.com. Yeah. This is a long time
ago. This was years ago. But there was this company that you know, said, hey, well, you can have a web wallet with us. We'll hold your Bitcoins for you. And so we thought, oh, that's convenient. And so we put some Bitcoins in this. And then this was back when Bitcoins were worth, you know, $2 a piece or something like that. Now they're worth $250 a piece. So we actually lost about 40 or 50 Bitcoins each because this company just disappeared basically with the Bitcoin. Now, ultimately, they came back and found half of them and gave half of the Bitcoins back to all of their customers. But, you know, what can you do to really go after these guys? You know, you've trusted your wallet to someone else. So what I'm hearing you ask about, Pete, is how can you secure your own wallet in addition to blockchain having it. Is that right?
Right. So, I know I need to have my private... Well, I mean, what if the website fails?
Exactly.
Or I don't know what...
Yeah.
I mean, if something happens and I can't access blockchain.info...
Yeah, that's a smart...
How am I going to get access to my wallet?
Smart question. That's something that everybody should be asking themselves if they've got a web wallet is... How do I access this thing if this wallet or this web company fails? Now, blockchain claims that, and I, you know, whether this claim is true or not, I don't know. I don't know if it's been independently audited, but they claim that they encrypt your wallet within the browser, and so therefore that blockchain themselves, they do not have access to the private key, meaning that when you log into the website, you, in that process, are decrypting the wallet that the wallet information that they have on file. So they cannot access it, that only you have access, which is why if you forget your password, you're screwed with blockchain.info.
Right.
So there are ways in the blockchain, sort of their settings menu, or there's a menu in there on the site where you can back up your wallet. And that's something that you'll want to do as soon as you can is to back up the wallet.
You actually can't reset your password. Well, you can reset your password, but if you lose it, you're out of luck.
You're screwed. Yeah. Right. So you can download a backup of the wallet, and then there are certain instructions you can follow to utilize that backup with some other wallet, you know, or with another sort of system, if you will, with like the standard Bitcoin wallet or some other options. And then there's also another way that you can get a QR code of your private key. So for listeners that are unfamiliar, with Bitcoin, there's a public key and a private key. So when you go to bitcoin.freetalklive.com and you see our Bitcoin address, that's our public key. You can use that to send Bitcoin to Free Talk Live. You give out your public key to anybody that you want to possibly send you Bitcoin. You do not give out your private key because the private key would allow that person to then access your Bitcoin and then send it to wherever they want. So the private key needs to be kept very, very safe. So whenever you download these backups, you also need to do something that will protect that file from, you know, being accessed by someone who you don't want to access it. So you do have to keep things secure and think about these matters. But there is a way to back it up, and there's also a way to sort of get a QR code, which I used actually to take my blockchain.info wallet and import that into a different wallet program. So I actually used the Mycelium wallet on my phone, which was my blockchain wallet as well. So I can actually go into the same wallet through two different systems.
Interesting.
I can open up my blockchain.info account and access that wallet there, and I can access the same Bitcoins through the Mycelium wallet. Did that help at all? Pete?
That does a little bit. What was the name of that second wallet?
Mycelium. M-Y-C-E-L-I-U-M. Mycelium. It's a good wallet for phones, but they don't have the web interface that blockchain does. Hey, thanks for the call. There are options to back up. Just hunt around through the blockchain.info menus or go into their help system, and I think you'll get more information there. And thanks, Pete, for your call tonight. It's important stuff to think about. You've got to protect your money. You're responsible for it.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. LRN.fm needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most.
please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. You can bring up anything that you want to discuss, 855-450-3733. Hey, don't forget, you can also join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. And if you do want to join us on Skype, send a contact request first to lrn.fm. You cannot get on without doing that. Once you've done that, and we'll approve it once we notice it coming in, which usually takes like a segment because basically I'm doing all that stuff here, kind of run the board on our side and host the show. So we'll approve it as soon as we can. And then after you're approved, you can call anytime on Skype. So again, Skype username lrn.fm if you want to participate in that way. Mark, you and I, we're taking off tomorrow morning, heading down to Austin, Texas for year number two of the Texas Bitcoin Conference.
Yep.
It's happening this year in downtown Austin, which I'm excited about because, you know, I've been to a lot of conferences. Mark, you and I, we go regularly to the Talkers Conference, which is a kind of a new media radio conference that happens in New York City. And I just like being in the city in a downtown environment for these conferences. I just feel like it's more conference-y that way, and or at least it's what I'm used to. And so I'm glad to hear that they're going to be having the Texas Bitcoin Conference in downtown Austin this year. Last year it was sort of on the outskirts in a racetrack location. This year it's going to be
It was big and it was a great convention, but
it was,
yeah, it was away from downtown.
But it was a little too big because you kind of had to walk for a ways to get to the convention rooms and things like that. And I suspect the Moody Theater is going to be a much better venue. It's right in the heart of downtown Austin, and it's happening March 28th and 29th. That's Saturday and Sunday. And by the way, it's not too late. I've been wondering all week, you know, is it too late to get tickets online? I finally went and checked it out here tonight, Mark. They are still available online. So if you've been waiting, and by the way, they haven't raised the price. There's not like been a last minute price jack either. So if, you know, you can actually go and get these tickets for $150. Oh wait, if you use code FTL, you'll save $25 off. So go now to TexasBitcoinConference.com. If you're going to be in the region of Austin, Texas this weekend, it's going to be worth the trip, especially if you're interested in Bitcoin. Whether you are new to Bitcoin and you're still asking the basic questions, or whether you're an expert, you've been involved for a long time, they're going to be the Bitcoin movers and shakers. A lot of them are going to be at this conference, including David Johnston, Jason King, Anthony DiOrio, Charlie Schrem, Robert Murphy.
Jason King is not going to be there.
All right, we'll cross him off the list. That's unfortunate.
Yep, he just found out.
Well, anyway, there will be others as well that I have not named. You can go to TexasBitcoinConference.com. We'll be there broadcasting live. Keynote speakers will include George Gilder, world-famous investor, economist, and author, plus Sambala Nair flying in from India. You know, it always happens, Mark, these last-minute changes at conferences. I know the Liberty Forum this year, there was Ben Swan, I think, was going to speak as a keynote speaker, and he had to cancel due to weather closing down the
D.C.
airport.
Nick Gillespie came in a little late and had to be shifted around.
Yeah. So these things happen. You don't, in my opinion, you should never go to a conference to see a speaker because something can happen. And then, you know, last minute, I remember, I think it was, I think it was actually William Grigg, who we've got an article from here tonight. Will Grigg, yeah, was supposed to speak at one of the Liberty Forums in the past, and one of his family members died right before the event, so he couldn't make it. So you never know what's going to happen to a guest speaker. The reason to attend the conference is because there's going to be hundreds of people there who you don't know yet. They're going to be people with whom you can network. Like I said, yes, there's movers and shakers, but there's also people who are in the same boat as you, and they just want to learn more stuff and meet other people who have similar interests. And that's what conferences are all about. It's about the networking. So we'll look forward to seeing you there at TexasBitcoinConference.com. Go and use code FTL. Save $25 off the already affordable $150 admission fee. And a portion of the admission fee will also go to benefit Sean's Outpost, which is a great Bitcoin-based charity helping the homeless in North Florida. That's TexasBitcoinConference.com. We'll see you in Austin this weekend. That's Saturday and Sunday in downtown Austin at the Moody Theater. And from what I understand, there's going to be a little pre-party on Friday night, Mark. There's going to be a taco party happening at a place called Maria's Taco Express, and we're hoping to get in town in time for that.
I suspect the tacos down in Texas are pretty good.
I'm told, actually, that this place is very good, as a matter of fact. Let's go to Virgil Vaduva. He's on the line calling from Ohio. Virgil, welcome back to Free Talk Live.
Good evening, guys. How are you?
Oh, great. You know, we were talking about your post earlier that you made on Facebook, which I don't know if it's public, but we went ahead and read it anyway because it sounded like you were trying to get it out there. It was about your trial this morning for panhandling, wherein you were found guilty. And what I found most interesting about the news, because we kind of expected that you were going to be found guilty, given that you could not talk about jury nullification to the jury and that you could not talk about the Constitution, your motivations behind what you did with violating this panhandling ordinance. What I thought was most interesting, and I didn't realize this, you probably told me, but it didn't stick with me, was that you didn't actually violate the panhandling ordinance, because in order to panhandle, you have to be panhandling for your own personal benefit, meaning asking people for money for Virgil Vaduva. You were actually going to donate this money. To whom were you going to give this money?
It's a local charity in town there. It's called United Volunteer Services.
So therefore, the people that are, you know, asking for money for the Salvation Army would not qualify as panhandlers. You should
That's
not
right.
have qualified as a panhandler. And you brought this up to the jury?
I brought it up. I tried to bring it up to the jury. It was first brought up with the jury outside of the room. The judge kept doing these, you know, jury, no jury type of going back and forth.
He
would kick the jury out and then bring him back in so we can talk about certain things. And I brought it up when the jury was out of the room, and I pointed out that I haven't even violated the law as it is written, because it's very clear that you may not ask for money for personal gain. That's what the law says.
And the judge who said that the Constitution won't be in her court said that the law won't be either.
Apparently that's the case. But yeah, that's an interesting point. Of course, when I tried to bring it up again with the jury in the room, the prosecutor objected and said that I was basically interpreting the law for the jury.
Ridiculous. And that was sustained?
Right. The judge only allowed me to read the definition as it is written in the law, not to explain what that means.
So it said for personal gain.
Right. It does say that. And I don't have it handy right now.
Did you get the impression the jury was full of dumb people?
Morons? I mean, yeah, that's what it sounds like.
I don't know. I mean, we are in the middle of Ohio here. No implications, you know, there. But yeah, there were some fairly smart software development guys on the jury and so on. But yeah, I mean, that just went right over their head.
Let's rewind a little bit here. What was the voir dire process like, where jurors were, you know, the selection of these jurors? How did that go for you before the trial started?
It went actually fairly straightforward. Believe it or not, though, a large percentage of they brought in like 30 or 40 people. Again, it blows my mind that they did this for panhandling, you know.
Yeah.
The courtroom was full of potential jurors. They're packed. But what I found amazing was that a large percentage of them were either government employees, you know, or former cops or current cops, or I don't understand how that's possible. Out
so
of all
basically, how many peremptory challenges do you get there in district court in Ohio?
Well, you get three.
Three.
You know,
so even though you had three challenges to knock out any juror, no questions asked, you still ended up with an actual cop
right.
on the juror the jury.
Not a cop, but a cop with all his relatives, a guy whose all the relatives were cops.
So you couldn't even knock out enough of these people to make it a fair jury of your peers.
Absolutely not.
Virgil, hang on. I got more questions. You've got time, right?
Sure.
All right, more with Virgil Vaduva in Ohio. He's been found guilty of panhandling. Sentencing to come on Tuesday. He's planning on appealing all the way on up to the federal courts if necessary. This is Free Talk Live.
You pick up the receiver. With your heart racing and sweat dripping from your forehead, you finally muster the courage to dial the number to call into your favorite talk radio show. It rings once, twice, and then...
Hello, it's GCN. What's your name and the state you're calling from?
Surprised you got through, you squeak out.
Jason from Minnesota.
Please hold.
As you patiently wait for your turn, you begin to daydream about being a famous talk radio host and what it would be like to have your own show.
Jason from Minnesota, you're up.
Millions of loyal listeners worldwide waiting to call and talk to you.
Caller, are you there?
Cheering crowds surround you, calling out your name.
Jason.
Going once, twice. Jason. Okay, we gotta move on to the next caller.
You blew it.
Huh? Wait, no!
Interact with the hosts you're listening to right now online at gcnlive.com. Click on the community link. Engage with other listeners. Ask questions. Start debates. Don't agree with the host? Let them know. Be a part of the community at gcnlive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing. To be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Free speech is protected on the internet, right? Not always. Government agencies try to limit free speech and commerce on the net. Luckily, when they do, the Institute for Justice is there to defend your First Amendment right to free speech. IJ helped set the first federal precedent for internet free speech in 1999, and ever since has worked to prevent unconstitutional roadblocks in cyberspace. Visit our website today at ij.org.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you about to meet the media? If you're about to be interviewed, do their homework for them. Know this about the person who will interview you. He or she is busy, so expect minimal, if any, preparation. He or she doesn't know as much about your topic as you do. He or she isn't as concerned as you are about getting your message out, so you need to take responsibility. Provide a biography and fact sheet, photographs, or other materials that tell your story. Reporters won't be put off if you supply frequently asked questions. Remember, Public Speaking 101, at the end of the speech, what's the one thing you want them to remember? You can download the document I supply to reporters who interview me and squirm through a video that demonstrates how not to conduct your media interview at www.survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free to bring up anything you want. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about the awful government court system, how the deck is stacked against you in more ways than you'd even expect. I mean, it may seem obvious once you think about it that the prosecutor, the judge, and in many cases the defense attorney are all working for the same group. They're all collecting a paycheck from the same organization. That kind of seems like an obvious conflict of interest. But then when you factor in these obedient, pathetic jurors and the level of ignorance that these people have, just willful ignorance and ignorance sort of built in by the system that's trained or sort of designed to basically make these people as clueless as possible about the system that they're participating in, you really, you know, it becomes a very difficult task to actually win a case. We'll continue here with that discussion with Virgil Vaduva, who was convicted today, this morning, of so-called panhandling, despite the fact that the definition of panhandling in the ordinance that is written against panhandling defines it as asking for money for one's own personal self, essentially. I'm paraphrasing. I don't have the actual definition in front of me, but that's my understanding of it, that in order to panhandle, I have to be asking for me. I want to buy some beer or alcohol or a sandwich or whatever. You know, I need it for a bus ticket. Those are all, it would be examples of panhandling under the ordinance. Virgil was doing it so he could give money to a local charity. By definition, that is not panhandling, but the jury found him guilty anyway. And we have Virgil back with us here. You weren't surprised by any of this, though, Virgil, although some in the audience may have been.
No, no, I was not surprised by this at all. The thing about the definition of panhandling, the reason I didn't talk about that was I was keeping it for the trial. I didn't want to write about it or talk to people in public about it. Mostly just to kind of be a little bit of a surprise. Obviously, it didn't make a difference at all.
It's fascinating. I mean, it's really fascinating. It's like nobody's thinking here. The police, the prosecutors, the judge, these people know that they're going to have a federal case on their hands. They know that these panhandling laws have been destroyed all over the country. Why in the world do they want to find you guilty?
Yeah, that's a good question. They even today, they put a cop, one of the cops that ticketed me on the stand, and he testified that he brought a tape measure thing with him to measure the distance from the door to where I was panhandling to make sure that it meets the 20 foot requirement under the law. It's amazing.
So you said that the trial took about an hour. I was looking at the video. It looks like about an hour and 40 minutes. And you said the jury deliberated for all of 20 minutes.
If that, maybe 15, 20 minutes, and they had a verdict. And as soon as they said that, I'm like,
Certainly. You're guilty. Yeah.
I'm guilty. Absolutely.
Well, I mean, you know, nobody wants to be in there and be the one person that's hanging that jury. It's a big pain.
Bother me.
Imagine. It's likely a fine that we're talking about here anyway.
Fine and jail time.
Well, I understand, but the people they're going to look at this realistically, right? It's not.
How do they know what's going to happen? I mean, Virgil, do you have any expectation? I mean, you've never been convicted of anything before, correct? Is this your first time?
No. No, this is my first time, and I don't know. This judge was pretty ticked off today when he found out about the FIJA trial, the FIJA flyers. So I'm not sure. Maybe he's pretty angry. Maybe he was.
Ooh, yeah. Tell me about that aspect. So you had activists out in front of the courthouse today giving flyers to the potential jurors. So jury selection happened today and the trial all on the same day?
That's correct. Yes, they both happened today.
Tell me about the jury outreach. What happened there?
Well, of course, I had nothing to do with that.
Well, of course, if I did,
I can't really.
Well, that would be because someone might be able to interpret that as jury tamper. I think we're losing a few packets from you, Virgil. Hang on a sec. So that would be because someone might interpret that as jury tampering. But technically, again, obviously these definitions don't really matter much to juries. But technically, the definition of jury tampering is where you try to encourage a jury to vote in a particular fashion. Jury nullification outreach is more of an educational thing where you just simply inform the jury of their right to vote their conscience. But nonetheless, obviously, you don't want to be associated with it if you can avoid it because of, well, the fact that these government guys will interpret the law however they want, and apparently so will the jury. So anyway, we're losing a few packets from you. I don't know if it's any better now. Go ahead and, yes, it looks better. So go ahead with telling us about that.
Yeah, that's true. So there were a group of people, they're handing out flyers, and right before the jury came in, the judge found out about one of these flyers, and he called both of us back there. He was clearly very angry, but he kept his composure. I got to give him that. He kept his, but it was apparent that he was upset.
He called you into chambers? You went into the judge's chambers?
Yeah, both of us. Yeah, he pointed out the flyer. He had the prosecutor look it over, and then he showed it to the jurors. He asked if anyone read it, how long, how much of it, and then he warned them to ignore everything in it.
Wow.
Now, let me ask you this, though. Did you get a chance to talk to him about jury nullification?
Ridiculous. No. Go ahead.
In the judge's chambers.
No.
Talk to the judge?
Yeah. Well, I mean, the judge, theoretically, if they, you know, he has any business being on the bench, should realize that this is a 1,000-year right.
Oh, man.
Jury nullification is completely legal in the United States. And this is something that the lawyer in types are trying to sort of, you know, shove under the rug. It's understood, but it's legal. Did you have a chance to talk to him about it?
Absolutely.
What do you say?
No. I've never seen that flyer before. I looked at it for a second and then I gave it back to him. I didn't talk to him at all about it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Because that would give him, you know, a clue that you might have known a thing or two about jury nullification, which, you know, you obviously do know about it,
right.
But that's not illegal. I mean, it's not illegal to know about jury nullification, but, you know, you don't want to get in deeper into charges you weren't expecting to face.
Yep.
So I think you made the right choice on that.
I was very angry, so I didn't want to go with that.
How were the chambers? I've never been in a judge's chambers before. Were they ornate? I mean, what was that like?
Yeah. He has a really big, nice oak desk, a couple of monitors on his desk. Yeah, very large chamber.
He's got a
nice
window.
Carpet on
How's
the floor.
It make you feel to have paid for that?
Big window.
Yeah.
Oh, and he has a little conference desk on the side, you know, with leather.
So he wasn't so happy.
He's got a couple of desks.
With the jury outreach. Did you ever talk to any of the outreachers, the people who were handing out the flyers, and ask them what their experiences were, like actually handing them out? Because a lot of times, you know, in different places, I remember my experience in Florida. It was like 50% of potential jurors would take whatever flyer I was handing out. Here in New Hampshire, it's like 90%. Do you have any experience there?
It was they said it was the exact same experience you had in Florida. About half of the people took them.
Yeah.
You know, so that's about it.
That's unfortunate. So, but then the judge tells them to ignore everything they just read if they actually did read the flyer. Now, that was presumably before the actual elimination process began, right?
Yes, that was before we selected the jury.
So jury was selected. You handled the trial yourself. How did that go for you? I mean, was it a nerve-wracking thing?
That's right.
Were you nervous?
No, I was not nervous at all. I do a lot of public speaking.
Okay.
And, you know, I didn't find it intimidating or anything like that. In fact, some people told me that I presented myself better than the prosecutor did.
Huh.
So.
Well, the prosecutor probably doesn't go to trial very often.
That's probably true.
I mean, we've had people call in on the show getting a trial. It's the first time they've had one in a year courthouse.
Virgil, where does this go from here? I mean, what's the next level court in Ohio? This was obviously the lowest level kind of district style court. Where do you appeal to?
I have no idea. I will have to find out next week what the appeal court is for our area. So I don't know.
Well, like I know that some states have another layer of courts. Here in New Hampshire, there's a superior court, but some stuff you can't appeal to superior. You have to appeal straight to the Supreme Court. If there's jail time involved in New Hampshire,
I hope that's not the case.
You hope that you don't have to go to Supreme right away, or you hope there is...
That would probably be a lot of work, and I definitely don't have the time or the nerves left to do it. But I've even been thinking about getting an attorney for the appeal, just so to get, you know, we can get this over an appeal. But we'll see.
Yeah, you know, obviously attorneys are expensive. Of course, you know, maybe you can reach back out to the ACLU. I know you said they were looking at your case, but they never got back to you. They might be interested in hearing an update on this. And Virgil, if you've got a little bit more time, I've got a couple more questions.
Absolutely.
All right, more with Virgil Vaduva, the illegal panhandler, coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Well, I did it. I finally left the empire behind. And now that I'm safely settled in Chile, I'm gathering with others like me to build a new community called Fort Galt. Fort Galt is designed to be the ideal home base for professionals and their families to live and work in peace. If you're ready to ditch the super state and bring your business to freer lands, visit us online at fortgalt.com. That's fortgalt.com.
We live in a complicated society. Stressful issues are always popping up. Have you ever been treated unfairly by someone? Have you ever been overcharged for a repair? Have you ever signed a contract or a document worried about identity theft? How many times have you been in those unique situations where you just wanted to call an attorney to find out if you're right or wrong or what your legal rights are? But every time you think about calling an attorney, what do you think about first? That's right. Who do you call and how much will it cost? Our friends at Legal Shield have found a solution. With a nationwide network of 6,900 attorneys who average 19 years of experience, Legal Shield's law firms take over 40,000 calls per week helping their members. For less than $20 per month, you can have access to Legal Shield on everything from the trivial to the traumatic. Let Legal Shield stand up for your rights at lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com. Or call 855-340-SAVE, 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Free Talk Live.
Most people, when it comes to what the government demands about their property, the zoning board or whatever department we're dealing with here that claims to have dominion over what you believe to be your property, most people just go along to get along because they understand that something nasty will happen if they don't. They understand that if they don't do what the people calling themselves government demand that they do, that eventually men with guns are going to come to their house, possibly just take it from them. And I think everybody inherently knows that there's a threat of violence behind what the government does. Oh, I know. You like to tell yourself stories about how it's the price of civilization to pay taxes. The price of civilization is zoning. It's the price of civilization to obey orders.
Well, don't forget the pig farm excuse.
Oh, sure, yeah.
If you didn't have zoning, somebody would open a pig farm right next door to you.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you dial toll-free. Bring up anything you want, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Drop on by freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features that we have on the site waiting for you once again. That's freetalklive.com. With you tonight, Ian here.
And Mark.
And don't forget, if you want to help support Free Talk Live, you can shop with us. Just go to shop.freetalklive.com. There's links there that'll hook you up with you don't get discounts or anything over at Amazon, but we get a cut of the sale when you enter through shop.freetalklive.com. And so we got Virgil Vaduva still on the line with us here. Virgil, welcome back to Free Talk Live.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks for sticking with us here through this discussion, because I think it's important. I think people, I think it's important for people to know how the system really works, because there's one story that you get told in school. Like, I remember going to a government class or whatever. When I was in high school, they had some sort of a government class, and there was like a section of that class about the court system, and they go through the basics of the attorneys and the judge and the clerk, and they just sort of they have a little mock trial, and it's all made to be like this big fair system.
You think that the laws are the things that they follow,
And said there's the second set of books?
Well, in this case, it was just the jury made up the law. Essentially, this was the jury legislating from the jury box.
Not really. I mean, the prosecutor brought this for a reason, right? The jury said to themselves, well, clearly, there's some reason to find this guy guilty. We're having a trial. So let's do that.
Yeah, they found you guilty, for listeners just tuning in, they found you guilty of panhandling, even though the law, the statutes in Xenia, Ohio, define panhandling as asking for money for one's own personal benefit. You were collecting money for charity, yet they arrested you anyway. And they know who you are, right, Virgil? I mean, you're kind of a local activist in that region of Ohio, and the police, you know, that were dealing with you on that day. It's not like right. You were some kind of strange element that they'd never encountered.
No, they know me very well. In fact, I asked the cop that testified today, I asked him how he knows me, and he admitted, you know, that he heard about me. And when I asked who reported this so-called crime, he said that, well, we got some information. And when I pressed him on it, he basically admitted that one of their own detectives came up to let him know that I was supposedly panhandling.
And well, this looks like they've got a complainant then. They complained to themselves.
Right. How did you sort of promote this in advance, right? Like, so how did they how would they have known that you were out there?
Well, they just, because it was right in front of their own building, the police station and the city hall and the city, pretty much all the city business is done in this building, so you can't miss it.
Yeah, so you picked the most obvious location to do this. And you were convicted by this jury. I guess, you know, my question again was, you handle the case yourself. So that means that you can talk to the jury, which to me, I think is a good thing. I think that being able to connect with these people, you know, make eye contact with them as you're talking to them, I think that's a good thing. Obviously, it didn't end up helping you because they found you guilty. But did you feel like maybe you had a chance at any point?
I did. Actually, before the jury was finally selected, there was this girl, well, young lady on the jury, and the entire time she smiled at me, right? She had a smile, and when they mentioned the potential charges, she had this look, panhandling, what? As if it was a really stupid charge. Mm-hmm. And she was one of the three folks that the prosecutor kicked out, because I think he noticed that. So.
Oh, man.
I know. So what are you going to do?
So, yeah. So you're not sure what comes next.
It's crazy.
You don't know which court that you're going to be appealing to. But another question I have, since you don't know that, do you know then if on Tuesday you are sentenced to jail, will you be able to stay out on appeal? You know, like if you tell the judge, I'm appealing that, sir.
You know what? I assume so. I make the assumption.
You should be careful.
That's it.
I made that assumption once
before. You could be right.
I made that assumption once before, too, and they carted my butt off to jail. So I know that in New Hampshire, and again, what happens in New Hampshire isn't necessarily going to be in any way relatable to what happens in Ohio. But in New Hampshire, once you're convicted of in a trial by jury, you go to jail. At sentencing, the next level of appeal is to the Supreme Court, and as far as they're concerned, you can sit in jail while you wait for that appeal to roll through the Supreme Court. So you should be prepared, even though, you know, you don't have any other convictions. Odds are probably pretty slim you'll end up in jail. But then again, like you said, the judge wasn't so happy about the jury nullification aspect of this. You should be prepared to spend 30 days in jail come Tuesday.
Oh God. I hope that's not the case, but we'll get there, you know, and we'll deal with it if that's the case.
I saw on your personal Facebook profile, your wife posted a picture of bringing the kids to court for kind of a field trip day. Boy, was that a lesson for them, I imagine.
Yes, I had a little chat with them, and they admitted they were very bored, but now they are understanding.
Boring as crap.
Absolutely. I mean,
you know,
it won't be boring when they put daddy in handcuffs and cart him away.
Courtroom drama, my foot. I mean, they say right on the door that they're the criminal court. Yeah. You know what? You know what's going to go on here. These are a bunch of bad people. They say they're a bunch of criminals right on the door. Apparently, the jury's in cahoots with them. They should call it the criminal jury, too.
Well, if you end up getting put in on Tuesday, we will commit to putting the address for the jail up on our Facebook page so people can write to you,
send you cakes.
Well, I appreciate that. I appreciate that, Ian.
Unless it's like a weekend, then there's no point in writing because you won't even get the mail. But hopefully, if anything, it will be no jail time. What was the potential fine again? A couple hundred bucks?
A couple hundred bucks or something like that. Yeah.
What happens in Ohio if you don't pay the fine?
That's a good question. I assume they put a warrant out for you. I imagine.
Are you planning on paying the fine?
I will probably offer it to make a donation.
That's always a fun one.
Yeah, we'll see how that goes.
No, my experience with that is that they never approve that in court. The judges in New Hampshire, when I've offered to, you know, pay the fine to a charity rather than the court, have always denied it in physical court. But whenever I make it in written form, they approve it. So you may want to consider, if you're not going straight to jail, you may want to consider going ahead and putting that in writing later if they deny you in open court. Because usually they don't want people to see them do that, which is why that's why I suspect they won't approve it in front of an audience.
Okay, that's a good suggestion.
I'm out of questions. Mark, do you have any for Virgil?
I'm just flabbergasted by this whole thing. I mean, there's no questions that I have.
You shouldn't be flabbergasted. I mean, come on. You've been in courts enough times to expect this is a
jury's
scam.
Finding people guilty of things that aren't in the law. I mean,
it's the same thing they did with the Bartholomew brothers in California.
Yep. And a demo here in Manchester. There's no doubt. Yeah. I mean, it happens. It's just crazy. It's crazy.
Well, Virgil, we'll hope to be hearing from you on Tuesday with details about sentencing.
Okay. I will give you guys a call, and you'll be the first to know.
All right, man. Thanks for the exclusive. I
appreciate
that.
Thank you so much.
Have a good
night. I appreciate your support, guys.
Oh, hey, by the way, Green County Herald, how do people find you there?
Green County Herald or greenherald.com or even truthvoice.com. Both sites will bring up good stuff.
Oh, I didn't know that was your site. Truthvoice.com?
Yep, truthvoice.com. Absolutely.
All right, cool. Thanks, Virgil.
Thank you, guys.
I appreciate that. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. Let's go to, we've got Paul on the line in Pennsylvania. Paul, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Oh, good evening. Thank you for taking my call.
Sure.
I just kind of wanted to give you some insight of how you can get a loaded or padded jurors. In the state of Pennsylvania, every 3 years, you're eligible to be summoned for a jury. And I just got mine this week. And the questions, even if you want to, you know, cop out or, you know, come up with a good excuse, you have to fill out a questionnaire. So they've already got your name, your address, your date of birth. And then they ask you for your race, whether or not you're employed, what you're currently employed at, and what your former jobs were.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how they can, like, pad and load the jury.
Yeah, that's true. That's one way. They certainly want to have people on the jury who work for the government if they at all can find those people. And, of course, most of those people are in the jury pool, given that most government workers have government identification. You know, in a lot of cases, in many states, jury pools are selected from either or both of voter registration or driver's licenses.
Also, the government is careful to make sure that their employees are encouraged to go to jury duty, whereas people in the private market, you know,
want to get out of it.
Yeah, right. Yeah. I mean, when I was called for jury duty, if I didn't show up for work that day, I wasn't going to get paid. So essentially, I was going to take a pay cut to go and do my civic duty.
Paul, do they also ask you of what organizations you are a member?
No, not in the summons. No.
Okay. Interesting.
Once you get there, there's a big long form where they ask you 20, 30 questions.
That's where they hit you with that. Okay, I gotcha. And was there more that you wanted to share?
Nope, that's it.
Paul, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Toll free number 855-450-FREE. If you're on hold, we got a whole hour to go, so stick around. We'll come back with more here in moments. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. You can also join us via Skype. That's what Virgil was on, by the way. That's why he sounded like he was almost in the studio with us. So Skype username is lrn.fm. There's more Free Talk Live coming up.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Are you predictable? When was the last time you surprised someone with something totally unexpected? At ProFlowers, we think predictability is boring. So we're making it easy for you to be unpredictable by offering our best-selling 100 colorful blooms for just $19.99. Plus, we're giving away a free glass vase with every order. But hurry, because this incredible deal ends this Friday. Go to ProFlowers.com, click on the blue radio microphone in the upper right corner, and enter the secret code 0700. That's ProFlowers.com, secret code 0700.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 26, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,205, up $10. Silver opened at $17.08, up 13 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $252.71. Today's metal prices are brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. In the news, a new study from the International Physicians for the Prevention of Nuclear War has found that the United States' war on terror has caused more than a million deaths in Iraq, Afghanistan, and Pakistan. The report points out that while the U.S.-led multinational force in Iraq, NATO, and other military operations have maintained statistics for American casualties, they have failed to track the number of foreign deaths. The study also says the U.S. government number ignore casualties, injured, or killed, involving enemy combatants and civilians. A new 9/11 Review Commission report examined how well the FBI implemented changes recommended following the September 11th attacks. The report suggests the FBI should expand domestic spying operations to include entire ethnic communities as part of the war on terror. The commission calls for domain awareness or monitoring of racial, ethnic, or religious groups in search of individuals who might become radicalized and commit acts of terror. The report also discusses the FBI using community outreach or infiltration of communities suspected of terrorism. Both the Democrats and Republicans are proposing legislative solutions to the Federal Communications Commission's recent net neutrality measures. Republicans have introduced legislation to codify the FCC's order, including prohibitions on internet service providers from blocking, slowing, or selling priority delivery of content to consumers. Leading Democrats have expressed an interest in working with Republicans to pass a bill that establishes net neutrality as law. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Looking to promote your business or cause to tens of thousands of loyal listeners? Well, for a limited time only, the Liberty Beat is offering you the chance to save big while spreading your message. It's simple. Just sign up for 3 months of advertising and get your fourth month free. Don't miss out on this unique opportunity. Just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise and use coupon code GCN in the Describe Your Company section. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 26, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. At the request of Iraq, the United States on Wednesday began airstrikes into Crete. CBS News reports the measure is taken in support of a stalled Iraqi ground offensive to retake the city from Islamic State of Iraq and Syria fighters. CBS News calls the bombing a significant expansion of the U.S. military role in Iraq. The newly proposed California Electronic Communications Privacy Act would require warrants for the use of Stingray cell phone surveillance, also known as cell site simulators. The California state bill was approved by the Senate Public Safety Committee on Tuesday. In other Stingray news, Senators Patrick Leahy and Chuck Grassley have sent a new letter to the White House seeking answers on the use of the devices, which can indiscriminately gather cell phone data. The senators said the Department of Justice's failure to answer questions has heightened their concerns. A new bill has been introduced, which would create a government-certified label for food that is not genetically engineered. Representative Mike Pompeo said the label would be voluntary for companies who want to advertise their food as GE-free. The bill would put authority for certification under the Agriculture Department. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at MyMagicMud.com. Support also comes from the Conscious Resistance Network. Videos, news reports, and articles from a spiritual anarchist perspective. Experience the Conscious Resistance at theconsciousresistance.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 26, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
The Tallahassee Zoo, which faced a major budget crisis. Luckily, they were able to get both, keep guests and animals happy, and stay profitable.
And that's thanks to the zoo's new director, Maxwell Jeffries.
Happy to be here. Thank
you. Good morning.
Now, what's the most profitable part of the zoo? The elephants, the tigers?
No. The gift shop, okay? Food court. But now, the entire zoo is the gift shop. So you come to the zoo, you look around, you see something you like, make me an offer. I'm a businessman. I want to make people happy. You're probably familiar with the old saying, don't feed the animals.
Oh, right, of course.
Okay, well, that's old-fashioned thinking. At our zoo, you can feed the animals.
Anything you want?
Anything you want. Oats, eggs, batteries, you name it. And we also invented a new tiered membership system. So for your standard membership, you go to the zoo, you get to see the animals. For your gold-level membership, you get to pick any two animals, make them fight each other. Yeah. And then with a platinum, you get 1 hour alone in the zoo. No questions asked. Yeah.
Wow.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome back to Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free and take control of the airwaves. The number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. It's Ian here.
And Mark.
Don't forget, you can join us online at freetalklive.com. Enjoy all the features on the site totally free. You get to create the content. What's there on the front page was put there by listeners like you. Submit whatever you want, and other listeners can then vote on it. Vote it up if they like, down if they don't. And the aggregate will know what you think's important, what you think's interesting. Of course, the best way to share what you think's interesting with us is to call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE or Skype at username lrn.fm. Coming up, we can talk about the story about the cop blocker who went it alone and, well, now he's looking at felony charges. We'll tell you about that here in a moment. Jordan is listening in Ohio. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Jordan.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
Hey, I don't know if you guys are still talking about the jury trial you were discussing with Virgil earlier, but I was in the audience at that trial, and I just wanted to chime in. Yeah.
Cool. How many people were attending? I didn't ask Virgil that. How many would you say were there to support him?
I'd say around 10, 12,
that's
a dozen.
That's excellent, I have to say. I mean, that's even good for being in New Hampshire to get 10 to a dozen people to show up. So, man, if you guys can roust up that level of support there in Ohio, you've got a pretty good thing going there.
Yeah, a lot of the local activists that know Virgil and support his case were there, so it's pretty wonderful.
Awesome. What was your experience that you wanted to share?
Well, I mean, this is my first time I've ever been in a courtroom. I've never witnessed a trial before.
Oh, wow.
And I didn't know what to expect. I mean, I didn't pay attention in civics class like anybody.
Mm-hmm.
But apparently I didn't miss much because I was just blown away at how stacked it is in the state's favor. And, you know, Virgil mentioned that everyone gets the same paycheck, but it's just the scope is so narrow. Everyone works together. The way they have to define all the language is so formal that it's like you can't approach it in a reasonable way. And I'm just blown away by the absurdity of the whole process.
Wow. Yeah, it is a shocker. I mean, especially even if you have preconceived notions going in.
Yeah, you do have preconceived notions going in. You've been told your whole life that you'd get a fair trial.
Surprise!
Was the fair trial down the hall? Was the fair trial, you know, like, who got convicted of the actual, of actually breaking a law in that court courtroom that day?
Well, I bet if you asked the prosecutor, yeah, he would say it was a fair trial.
Yeah, he won.
I would have zero hope of ever being found not guilty if I had to face a jury. I have zero faith in the system whatsoever after witnessing that.
That's how I feel here on the show. We had talked for years about jury nullification, and I'm not against jury nullification or the education that surrounds it. Ian, you do jury nullification education monthly?
Pretty much every month, yeah. Whenever there's a jury being selected, I'm out there.
Yeah, I'm not against it, but I'm almost like... why even bother? Even it would be very difficult for me to do the activism that you do. I don't do it because I think you do it just because we can say that it's done every single month.
Well, I do it on principle. I don't do it because it's something we can advertise. I do it
not
because
something
it's the
because
right
it's effective.
Do.
You don't do it because it's effective, do you?
Well, we don't know how effective it is. I presume it's not that effective because, you know, well, first of all, they don't have jury trials that often, number one, because most people take a plea deal. But number two, when we've been able to talk about jury nullification during a trial, because here in New Hampshire, you can talk about it. In Virgil's trial, he was prevented from even bringing it up, but you can actually you can tell the jury about it in New Hampshire. Of course, we also tell them outside the courthouse with flyers and things like that, but the defendant can actually talk about it. And still, that it hasn't happened. There was only one trial that I know of where it actually happened in New Hampshire, where jury nullification actually occurred. And that didn't have to do with people handing out flyers to the jury. That had to do with a Free State Project participant, Kathleen, being on that jury. So she knew about jury nullification, and she managed to tell the rest of the jury to convince them to flip the verdict. She flipped 11 other people from guilty to not guilty by being, you know, steadfast enough and informed enough to actually, you know, clue these people in. So it can happen, but it is very, very rare, even when juries are informed about jury nullification. It's really a bummer.
Well, even the judge, he at one point said, when he was addressing the jury and he was telling them how the process worked, that it is not their job to figure out if a law should be there or not. So he actually said it is not their right, it is not their duty to determine for themselves if the reason this person is in the courtroom is legitimate or not.
Yep, that's a lie. Yep, he just lied to them.
In fact, that's not the only crazy thing he said. There's one point where he was, again, making some of his opening remarks, and he said, the state reserves the right in certain instances to limit free speech. And he said that before he introduced the panhandling law, familiarized the jury with it. Actually, the entire courtroom burst out in laughter, and he was so pissed off.
Right, because the jury was actually sitting there when people were laughing at him, right?
Yeah, and he said, if you have an outburst again, I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
No. Right? Oh, you're just going to ask, Judge?
Yeah,
I have a feeling you won't just be asking.
He gave the analogy of yelling fire in a crowded theater. And that's such a fallacious argument. It's a fallacy. So
yeah,
it's
it is
ridiculous that these people that have gone to school for 6, 8, 12 years have such an ignorant understanding of words and how to address people. And it's really, frankly, pathetic.
Wow, man. Well, you know, I'm sorry that was. I guess I'm not sorry. I mean, that's just. It's a bummer that you have to experience these things, but. I guess it's important to experience.
I guess I'm not shocked.
Them.
My eyes are just open, so I'm definitely more a person for the cause, even more than before.
Right on, man. Well, anything else you want to share about your experience today?
No, guys. Thanks for having me on.
One other question. Did you happen to be outside when Dio from copblock.org confronted these jurors?
I did not witness it, but did Virgil tell you how the exchange went?
Essentially, there was one black juror who was brought where it was pointed out that slavery was once legal, and he basically said, "But that was in the past."
That's precisely, he just saw it as a violation of the law, and that's all that mattered. You know, the morality is not an issue for him to care about.
Yep, the Fugitive Slave Act, you know, Quakers holding black people in their basements to keep them from the slave catchers was just a violation of the law.
Exactly.
Thanks, Jordan, for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I'm really glad to hear of that turnout, too, because, you know, most of the time in most places when people go to court, they're lucky if mom or dad will show up to support them. They're lucky if their wife or husband will come out and support them in court. And it can be a really lonely process and a lonely, frustrating, scary experience. So to have people there backing you up, to have someone there, you know, operating a video camera, to have DO from Cop Block outside trying to talk to the jurors as they're going out of the courthouse, that's huge. I mean, good on those activists for taking time out of their schedule to come support Virgil today. Now,
it's a big turnout.
Yeah, that's awesome. And the more people we can have move to New Hampshire, the larger the turnouts we'll have. And it's really interesting to be in a courtroom where you've got a majority of the audience that is not standing for the judge. They're laughing at the absurdity of the state. And I think that, you know, I don't know what kind of an effect that has on a jury, but it definitely must have some sort of an effect to have people not taking this judge as seriously as he would like to be taken. So as more time goes by and more liberty activists move to New Hampshire, and Virgil's a member of the Free State Project, which is the idea of moving 20,000 liberty-loving people like you and I, Mark, we're early movers for the Free State Project, moving to New Hampshire to get active to achieve more liberty in our lifetime. One of the benefits of having a large concentration of activists is there's a greater chance one of them might be on your jury. You know, there's a possibility that that could happen, that that in a jury being selected, one may be a Free Stater. And further, one you don't even know is a Free Stater, right? Because, you know, there are already 1,700 people who are here now as part of the Free State Project. I don't know who they all are. If one of them should, because, you know, you're not supposed to be on the jury of someone you know, even though in theory you're supposed to have your peers on there, but they'll eliminate you if you have some sort of conflict like that. But if you don't know the person, but yet they're also a liberty-loving activist, then that's an ideal situation, is it not, to actually have someone who not only knows about jury nullification, but is willing to exercise jury nullification on your jury?
Sure.
Would be incredibly valuable. If we've got 20,000 liberty activists, that increases the odds of that happening. So either way, having people in your corner is a huge help. And going lone activist is never a good thing to do, in my opinion. I don't blame people for wanting to do it. I know, you know, wherever you are in the United States or around the world, you feel like you've got to do something about the runaway government, the insane madness of the system. And I don't blame anyone for going out there and, you know, sticking their neck out. But if you're alone, it can be a really scary process, especially when they come after you with felony charges for making a Facebook post. You thought Virgil's case was bad? What do you hear this one we've got coming up for you in moments? 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. That's 855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Well,
with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think
you
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make...
Wait, now. Wait a minute.
Holy crap. Whoa.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared me.
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited to bring up whatever you'd like. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Skype in, username lrn.fm. With you in studio, Ian here.
And Mark.
And ProXPN can help protect you on the internet. Right now, your internet service provider, if you're not using ProXPN, they're probably logging every website you visit, every search term you enter. In addition to that, your Wi-Fi packets may be in jeopardy because if you're not using ProXPN, then you're not encrypting your internet connection. And so people with packet sniffers may be trying to snag your bank account info or your credit card info and things like that, passwords, etc. So grab ProXPN. Their software is free. You can download it for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android devices, even Linux as well. ProXPN.com/FTL is where you go to get started. And when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account for unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, you can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. Use code FTL50 to get 50% off the price of their annual account. That's about $5 a month, just a little less than $5 per month for some great protection for your privacy. Use code FTL50 at proxpn.com/FTL. There's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose but your privacy. And ProXPN, by the way, does not keep records of your online habits at all. So proxpn.com/FTL. Code FTL50, which, by the way, locks in your discount for the lifetime of the account. So a year later, when you want to upgrade or, you know, continue on for another year, you still get the same great discount. Again, proxpn.com/FTL. Use code FTL50 and get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. Let's go to Carl, calling from Cleveland. Carl, you're on Free Talk Live via Skype. Do we have Carl?
Yeah, Carl. Hi. Thanks for taking my call.
Oh, our pleasure. Go ahead, sir.
Yes, I wanted to talk to you about the amendment that Rand Paul, he was in the news today, he proposed to increase military spending by some $160 billion. Now, I realize that, Rand Paul, he catches a lot of flack in the anarcho-capitalist community, you know, people saying, oh, he's not a real libertarian, you know. Now, I don't consider myself one of those purists. I always think that, you know, something is better than nothing. You know, that if he got elected, we would be in a better place than if he didn't. But I can't wrap my head around, you know, why he would propose this amendment when it goes against pretty much everything he's been saying up to this point. I was wondering what you guys felt about this.
Does that go against what he's been saying? I'm not real sure that's the case. I mean, he's never really seemed to be a real peace-oriented person like his father. I've never heard Rand. I mean, I gotta admit, I don't pay close attention to him, but every now and then I'll see some news story about him. I've never seen Rand Paul talking about shutting down military bases or anything like that.
He seems to take a more measured approach than most to foreign policy issues, most Republicans at the very least.
Well, he might be better than George Bush or Barack Obama, but you know, he's certainly not his dad.
Well, he's never been president. He really should be compared to senators, because
George Bush said he didn't want a nation build, and look what he did. So you got Rand Paul saying he wants to increase the military this much. Who knows what he'll do when he actually gets power in his hands?
You know, what my thought process on this is that Rand is a political creature, and this is pretty distasteful to those of us who don't particularly like politics. He's decided to take a different tack than Ron Paul did. Ron Paul took a tack of using his platform as educational. I don't know what he plans with this, but I can tell you he has upset a lot of, you know, more hardline libertarians out there. And I'm not prepared to stand here and attempt to defend what he this increase in spending. I am curious as to how it's going to sort of play out. What I have found over time is that those that support Rand can usually proffer some kind of explanation as to what he may be trying to do, and that explanation often placates me to some extent. As long as I understand and accept the fact that Rand Paul is a political creature attempting to reach the highest office in the land.
See, I don't accept that. I don't accept that he's a political creature, because that to me means he's a liar, and I'm not interested in supporting liars. I like Ron Paul because I always felt like he was honest about what he's saying, and the Rand Paul defenders, usually the best defense they have for him is, well, he doesn't actually believe what he's saying, he's just trying to get elected. Well, I'm sorry, I'm not going to support somebody who's doing that, because that's dishonest. What do you think, Carl?
I think you're right. The only thing I can think of is that I really do feel as though he wants less government, you know what I mean? I can't creep crawl into the guy's hot head, you know, and know for sure. But just from the things he says, you know what I mean? It seems like he wants less government. However, just like you were saying, you know, he seems to be much more political than his father. He seems to want to play the game, so to speak. You know what I mean?
Well, the game's going to get played. whether we like it or not, the game is going to be played. The question is Rand Paul on our team or not? And
that's pretty clearly he's not on my team.
Well, you don't want to play the game.
I've run for political office, so I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, but
I ran for governor.
You use the political running, and you've said yourself that you use this as a platform to talk about the ideas of liberty.
Yeah, shouldn't that be what we're doing as liberty-minded people, is to actually spread the ideas? Because you're not going to get liberty if you trick people. They're not going to all of a sudden be warmed up to the ideas of freedom if Rand Paul, if he's like, you know, what you some people actually believe, and that he's just pretending to be a statist so he can get elected. You're not going to be able to trick people into liberty. You're going to have to get them to want it. You're going to have to get them to understand it. And Ron Paul brought a level of understanding to the American people that heretofore, at least in my lifetime, has never occurred before. There's more people in the liberty movement now singly because of Ron Paul and his efforts. That man did an amazing job in 2008 and 2012. And his son's not even gonna, you know, a shadow of what his father has done. Carl, any other thoughts you want to share?
No, that's it. Thanks for taking the call.
Hey, I appreciate your call tonight. Let's talk to James. He's in New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, James.
Hey, guys. So I was listening to the podcast where you guys were talking about the Batman and Batgirl cover with the Joker on. I guess that was triggering some folks.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. Well, the whole concept of triggering is actually sort of near and dear to my heart. So I guess my backstory is that I was stabbed pretty violently when I was a freshman in high school.
Yikes.
While I was at school. And it's a really upsetting thing to happen, obviously.
Yeah.
What was it over, if I might ask?
Yeah, it was a really silly situation. So, there's a guy who I played basketball with in middle school, and he came up and kind of punched me on the arm the way guys do, and I turned around and kind of punched him back, and like there were some friends of his around him that were like, you know, oh, curses, a white guy snuck him, he hit you, you know, what are you going to do about it type of thing. And, you know, this kind of thing happened in my high school from time to time, and I just started walking away, and the next thing I knew, I saw some like horrified looks from people coming the other direction, turned around, and he was coming at me with a knife.
So the same dude who like hit you in a friendly way then stabbed you after you hit him back.
That's pretty crazy. It was the strangest thing that ever happened.
We'll come back with the triggers here. Hang on, James. We'll bring you back here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. You can bring up what you'd like here on Free Talk Live.
The freeze-dry guy, leader in the preparedness industry for 44 years, is closing his California warehouse. Don't miss out on this huge warehouse sale and receive discounts from 30 to 40% off on the finest Mountain House and Packaway brand freeze-dried and dehydrated foods for long-term food storage or even everyday use. Plus deep discounts on all in-stock survival gear. The freeze-dry guy is offering a wide selection of freeze-dried foods in number 10 cans and even individually packaged entrees. Remember, meats, vegetables, fruits, and long-range patrol rations are the main components for any long-term food storage. This is limited to stock on hand, so hurry and call 866-404-3663 or 530-798-4414. Remember, as always, free shipping to the lower 48 states. So hurry up and call 866-404-3663 or 530-798-4414. Remember, this is limited to stock on hand. The freeze-dry guy is your choice for survival food in an uncertain world.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. A man age 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The 3 most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are 1, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Now, more Free Talk Live. Plenty of time for you to dial toll-free to bring up what you'd like. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online at freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features waiting for you there. They're completely free. freetalklive.com. You know, these days, people use battery power on so many things, it's hard to really even keep track. But there's a new device that'll help you keep your battery-powered devices up and running. It's so frustrating to have a smartphone that's so damn smart it can't even stay on for more than 4 hours of continuous use.
Sometimes I think 4 hours is generous.
It's what we've got now is the Pocket Power Plus. It's a source of backup power that's so small you can put it in your pocket or the glove box of your car. And it's so powerful, though, in some circumstances it can actually jumpstart a car. Sounds crazy. But it's not. It's the Pocket Power Plus, and it's
based- we saw this on video, by the way. I mean, we looked it up when the product was going to be. We're going to do an endorsement. We're lucky to have them. I know that some major, at least one major talk show host, is also endorsing this product.
So it's a breakthrough in portable power technology. It looks like a battery pack, but it's what's on the inside that's really important here. You can go to PocketPowerPlus9.com. You'll learn a lot more about it, including about the polymer lithium-ion battery that is the breakthrough they're talking about here. If you get stranded, you're in an airport, you're in a car, you just want to get off the grid for a while, the Pocket Power Plus becomes your own personal mini power plant. You can run electronic devices for hours, even days, if necessary. And they can also, the Pocket Power Plus can deliver an enormous supply of on-demand power. It's got a full accessory pack with most adapters you could possibly need, including the jumper cables. Plus, the best part is Free Talk Live listeners like you can now get the Pocket Power Plus for half price. Just go to PocketPowerPlus9.com. You can spell the 9 or put the number in. Either one works. That's PocketPowerPlus9.com and use coupon code FTL and you'll save even more. That's PocketPowerPlus9.com. As we go back to James in Dover, James, you were talking about triggers. You said that in your high school experience, you were unfortunately stabbed by someone that you were going to high school with, and that sort of was the beginning of your story. So go ahead.
Oh, sure. So anyway, after this happened, I was kept out of school for a little while, and for quite some time after that, just the sight of, big knives or, and even though I wasn't stabbed by a very big knife, it was kind of like a small Swiss Army type thing, but, the sight of big knives or, like violence with cutting type things in either video games or movies or things like that, would cause like a reaction in me, just like this kind of flight response, like my heart racing and getting short of breath and sweating and things like that. And it was really awful. And my close friends and family could see it would happen. And they learned to become cautious around me. And of course, I was like pretty embarrassed about the whole thing because, as a young man, you don't want to be scared at someone cutting a pepper on a counter or whatever.
Sure.
But at some point, I got really frustrated with this, this thing I would sort of have to explain to the people I was close with. And I just decided that it wasn't who I wanted to be anymore, I guess. I didn't want to run away from people for cutting bananas or whatever. And so every time this would happen to me, I just tried to work hard to get through it, to actually even just watch it happen, purposefully seek out, video games where these sorts of things would happen, especially in private where I could, work on it. And it was very challenging, and it took me quite a while to sort of work through. Because I just had to rewire my brain to remind it that, simply seeing a knife didn't mean that I was going to get stabbed again.
How many years did you go through this until you made this decision to change your mind about it?
Yeah, I don't even know if it was over the course of a whole year. It was probably like 10 months to a year.
Okay.
This is almost 20 years ago now, so it's hard to picture precisely. But
was it incremental? Or was it all at once? So were you, scared? Did it bother you, a great deal the whole way through? And then at one point or another, you're just, everything's fine? Or was it sort of something that over time you're like, it was getting better and better as time went by?
It was something I sort of forgot about over time. Like it became sort of this ritualistic thing I would do. Of course, this before the internet, this would have been a lot easier to to do then. But I would sort of ritualistically seek out these sorts of things and, you know, look at the knives in my kitchen or whatever and even handle them. And then I just started forgetting to do it. And then one day it just like occurred to me that I was at a friend's house and his mom was cutting something up and it just didn't bother me. And I guess like my thoughts and my feelings towards people who are triggered by things is, first of all, like I know this is a real thing and it's really hard and just terrible. But I don't think that we necessarily do people who are going through those things any favors by sort of insulating them from what would amount to sort of day-to-day experiences, you know, especially in the internet era. Like, you know, no victim of sexual abuse is ever going to be able to avoid, that sort of idea ever crossing their airwaves, you know. No victim of violence is ever going to be able to avoid hearing about or observing or encountering at least faux violence in some capacity. And so, you know, I wonder if you continue to avoid it and continue to sort of try to insulate yourself from it, if you just actually make it worse, you know, you sort of give those ideas and those images power over you. And it's not a good place to be, you know. It's something that would keep me up at night. And, it was, like I said, embarrassing and really upsetting. But
I bet. Wow. Thanks for sharing that. I think that's useful because hopefully other people, you know, in similar circumstances can be empowered by your story and try to find that power inside of them to overcome this difficulty. James, anything else you want to share?
I'll talk to anyone there struggling with it, but that's it. Thanks for the show, and keep listening.
Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Patrick on the line on Skype. Hello, Patrick.
Hey, I was going to make a joke about the last guy with the triggering thing, because I think a lot of people who you throw out the word triggering are kind of just like, they need to get through it and they need to work hard to get over themselves. I mean, I think a lot of things are scary, but like a lot of time people say, oh, don't, like I heard a recent story where they couldn't clap at a conference. You had to shake your hands jazz style because clapping triggered some people. I'm like, if you got to make everyone else a company to you, you know, like do things for you, I think you've taken too far. I think if you need a problem, you can seek out help from other people, but you need to work on it like that guy did. I think that guy did the exact right thing, but
it's a good story.
At some point or another, it gets ridiculous, right? Like we have to stop clapping at a conference because somebody might be triggered by it. It might disturb people. But why wouldn't people be disturbed by all these hands fluttering in the air doing the jazz hands things too? I mean, what about the people that are disturbed by that? Exactly. Where do we stop? We've already stopped clapping. Now we're going to stop the jazz hands. We can't stomp our feet. What are we going to do? At some point or another, the world must mourn for your terrible thing for as long as you want it to. And if you allow that to happen, then 7 billion other people must mourn too.
Yeah, a lot of bad things happen to people. You know, bad things happen to people. It
happens. Bad things happen to people.
Guaranteed.
So we can work to get through it. We can work to resolve those problems or, you know, make amends. But, you know, telling people to behave in a weird way just because you've had a bad experience, you know, unless they're close friends, they want to do it for you. You know, asking the public or asking a whole school to not do something, I think is a little ridiculous.
Right. Well, it's almost like letting your difficulty, your traumatic experience become trauma for other people.
Well, it's not letting, it's demanding.
Yeah.
That's really what it comes down to, is I have been hurt. I am terribly hurt, and you must respect my hurt. I hold my hurt hold a great deal of value around my hurt, and I'm going to hold on to it as long as I want to, and you are going to do it with me. And it's disgusting. It's a disgusting way to be.
Patrick, other thoughts?
Yeah. Have you guys heard about Jeremy Clarkson from Top Gear? Yeah.
He got fired.
The host of that show. What about
the host of the show? He got fired for punching a guy, which I'm not for punching people, but so I read a joke online about how maybe he just molested some kids. Maybe he still have a job.
Who is it that molested kids that still has a job?
Well, like the Jimmy Savile thing where you enlist people and you keep your job. Yeah, that sort of
Jimmy
thing.
Savile, the entertainer from the UK who for decades had allegedly molested people in a children's hospital, or actually just a regular hospital, people all the way up into their 40s. Thanks, Patrick, for the call tonight. But, you know, of course, she wasn't convicted of that. And no one really ever proved that he did it, but there were a lot of people who said he did. More coming up.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Brink of Freedom is a community-based network and magazine whose mission is to provide you with the information you need on your walk to freedom. From homesteading and gardening to tactical and firearms, Brink of Freedom provides everything you will need to gain the knowledge to be self-sufficient. If government doesn't like it, Brink of Freedom will cover it. Come share your knowledge and gain the knowledge of industry professionals within the community. Become a premium member and gain access to unlimited content and discounts on products and services from our merchants. Use the discount code FIENDS at brinkoffreedom.net.
So we decided to upgrade the look of our home.
You know, improve the curb appeal.
We decided to add the look of stone to the exterior.
We really like the stacked stone look.
Yeah, but when I checked into the price, it was ridiculous. No way could we afford it.
Then a friend told me about Genstone. Genstone.
Genstone comes in lightweight panels made of polyurethane. They've actually engineered the hassle out of installation. No mortar, no mesh. It was easy. Even I could do it.
We just screwed the panels to the wall and it looks like stone. I mean, it really looks like stone.
Yeah, from the box to the wall in minutes.
We love the look of our home now.
And Genstone is durable, comes with a 25-year warranty, and offers additional R-value for insulation.
If you want the look of stone at a price you can afford, call Genstone.
At 855-955-STONE.
Trust me, you'll save money.
And you'll love the look.
855-955-STONE. That's 855-955-7866.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here. Bring up whatever you'd like. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And if you enjoy Free Talk Live and you've ever listened to our internet network, LRN.FM, it's also available on free-to-air satellite across North and Central America. It was, up until February 18th, available on free-to-air satellite above Africa. But unfortunately, our satellite provider took it off the air, and that's basically because they were giving it to us for free. We had it, we had the channel over Africa for 2.5 years.
Hard to blame them, right?
Gratis. And yeah, I mean, thank you for putting us up that long. I knew the day would come, and it came last month. So now we've put together a fundraiser to try to raise $22,000 with the hope of being able to get back on satellite in Africa. And, you know, if we can actually raise enough, then we will be able to get back on. So I'm excited about the possibility. It was really cool to hear from people in Cameroon and elsewhere in Africa who have been listening to LRN.FM, listening to Free Talk Live and the dozens of other great liberty-oriented shows. And I'm happy to say that we've been going for 8 days now with a fundraiser. And we're not quite to 10%. We're at 8%.
Well, that's not too bad.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy about
that. I'm kind of surprised.
So, and you know, all things considered, Mark, if you actually look at,
because I thought, you know, some people would just say, it's not worth reaching Africa, you know, so what can they do to forward the ideas of liberty, which I think is, you know, obviously not an ideal that I support, but I was, you know, just wondering, and it sounds like people, they agree with me. It's worth reaching everybody.
Yeah, I mean, we've had donations as small as a dollar and as large as $700. The average, if you average it out, there's 16 contributors so far. The average donation is $114, which is pretty impressive. Like, a lot of people have been giving a lot to this fundraiser, and, you know, all things considered, this certainly has not gone viral. You know, like the video that I have, a little 4-minute long video that pitches this idea, only has 243 views. And that's a week in. You know, I mean, if we had 2,000 views on that video, would we have 10 times the donations? I don't know, but I'd like to find out.
Sure wouldn't hurt.
Yeah. So if you don't mind, please go to africa.lrn.fm. That'll forward you directly to the Indiegogo campaign, which has the video on it. It's got the, you know, the text pitch as well. It'll give you more information about it. You'll hear from Akko, who is the one of the guys from Africa that has actually called the show and has told us a lot of, you know, kind of connected us with what it's like living there and, you know, the government there and how oppressive things are. And so, you know, please share the link as well. Please, you know, if you've already given to the campaign, then hit the share button on there or just drop africa.lrn.fm into your favorite social bookmarking website, Facebook, etc. It makes a big difference for us. And we've got another 7 weeks basically here to wrap this fundraiser up. I think we can
do it. Still need to pick up speed, but yeah.
I think we can do it. I mean, if this video starts getting around the Liberty community, right now it's barely even hit a fraction of our listeners, let alone the Liberty community at large. So please go to africa.lrn.fm. Now, I said we were going to talk about this story about this lone cop blocker, but this is a long story, and I hesitate to really get into it. So I'm going to put that one on hold, and instead we can talk about the FCC. One of my least favorite government agencies.
Because they control our jobs.
Well, not really. I mean, they don't control Free Talk Live. We voluntarily follow their rules so that we can get on more radio stations. They control the radio
stations. And remain on the radio stations we're on.
Yeah, they control the stations that we're on. And if we, you know, violate their rules, then we could get kicked off those stations. And to us,
we would just be a podcast.
Yeah, to us, spreading the message of liberty is worth not saying the F-bomb. So we don't.
And I'd like to point out, I posted that Free Talk Live broke into the top 40 radio shows in America.
Yeah, I think
yesterday.
You mentioned that on the show too on Wednesday.
Yeah, I did. But I mentioned that on the Facebook page, and somebody said, "Radio, what's that?"
It's cute.
It's cute, right? But well, what my response to that was is, being a radio guy, I happen to know it's the most listened to media in America. That's what it is.
Yeah, 90-something percent of Americans listen to radio on a weekly basis.
Right. If you think about the people that don't have television sets, now they may watch a video because they watch on the internet or whatever, but think about the people that don't have internet. They don't have.
There aren't that many of them, but they do exist.
They do. Do 90% of Americans have internet and go on a weekly basis?
I don't know. Probably not.
See the ads? Yeah, probably not. That's because radio, still number one most consumed media in America.
Yeah, and it's good to be there, too. I mean, you can make the argument that, oh, ha-ha, you know, radio's dying, internet's going to rule, and that's probably maybe going to come true someday, but not anytime soon. You know, radio's a more than 100-year-old technology, and it's, you know, it's sticking around because it's got life left in it. You know, there's a lot you can say about radio and why some of the things about it, at least the stations that exist, leave a lot to be desired, and many of those critiques are valid, and I will engage in those same critiques. I mean, the corporatization and the consolidation of the radio industry has led to homogenization of the content, and you know, if everybody's trying to
be not great.
If everybody's trying to be Rush Limbaugh, then obviously that's not going to get a bunch of people to listen to talk radio. So, you know, Free Talk Live is different. We're a breakout show. We're the only show on, you know, only liberty-oriented show that is on as many stations as we are. We're on over 150 radio stations today. There's another good show, Freedom Fiends. It's on a few dozen stations. And we are the premier pro-liberty show out there. And unfortunately, there aren't very many others. I mean, maybe someday there will be, but right now, we're pretty much it as far as, you know, the upper level talk show hosts. And I wouldn't even say that we're second or first tier. I think maybe we can call ourselves third tier now.
We can call ourselves top 40.
Yeah, we're in the top 40 according to Talkers Magazine, and they are the authority on these matters. So this is actually where the story comes from, is Talkers Magazine, talkers.com, reporting on what is the FCC's biggest fine ever. And
yep.
A lot of people have been thinking that, oh, well, the Democrats are in office, you know, Barack Obama is the president, and so therefore the FCC is, you know, sort of been interpreted as being a little more
They're
going to
be nice now.
Yeah, they're supposed to be a little more open to sex talk or you know, profanity, and that's sort of been the suggestion, but this fine suggests otherwise here. This is the largest fine ever. It was announced against television station WDBJ of Roanoke, Virginia, $325,000, which, by the way, as I understand it, is the maximum. I don't believe the FCC can fine higher than that. What did they receive this fine for? Well, a penis.
Not just a penis, but a mistaken penis. And I think this is important, right? Like, if you're going to teach your child not to do something, you're going to employ punishment. You probably should reserve your maximum punishment for things that are done willfully.
Right, when they break a vase on purpose rather than
they're looking you right
accident.
In the eye, they pick the vase up and they throw it on the floor, daring you. Yep. Just go ahead. Go ahead and do your darndest, daddy. I mean, that's one thing. But if you know... They break a very valuable vase, because I think that putting a penis on the air, right? Like, that's a, whoa, whoops.
Oh, yeah. Who cares about this damn penis?
That's you that feels
that
way.
The idea that children need to be protected from penises is ridiculous.
Is this going to protect anybody, though? This was a mistake.
You want to protect your kids from having a penis inserted in them without their consent, but, you know, seeing one on television, I don't see that as the end of the world, but apparently the FCC does. And by the way, this ran during the news on WDBJ. It was a story about a retired
porn
star.
Not something that kids are known to be watching really closely.
Now, it was a 6 o'clock news, so the argument is the kids are awake, but
I'm not claiming they're not awake.
Nonetheless.
They're probably just not watching your news.
No. Harmony Rose, who was working as an EMT, a retired porn star, the broadcast of the story, a visual image of a porn site for which the star had worked, was shown in the corner of the screen while putting the story together. No one who worked on the story noticed a penis was viewable on the image of the website, according to WDBJ, which
is... one squinting little Christian in Roanoke found
it.
My
God, there's a penis! which has never been fined in the past. No history of violations. The image was not even viewable on the editing machines used to create the story. I don't understand that.
Well, they have the machines that they put... they had a smaller screen that they used for the editing.
Oh, I see what you're saying. According to WDBJ President General Manager Jeff Marks, quote, "We're surprised and disappointed the FCC's decided to propose a fine for WDBJ for a fleeting image on the very edge of some television screens during a news broadcast."
Because they really can't do anything about a fleeting expletive. So if somebody drops the F-bomb, they can. Well,
they can.
Not as I understand the interpretation of the laws these days.
Well, I don't know, Mark. I mean, that's been the concern.
I'm not advising anybody to fake a fleeting expletive, Ian.
Well, that's been what people have thought, was that a fleeting expletive would be more acceptable under the Obama administration. But this fleeting penis certainly wasn't acceptable.
Certainly not. There's a bit of a difference between an expletive and a penis.
Now, apparently the station is planning to somehow appeal this. I don't know what that process is like. But I imagine $300,000+ is going to be a big hit to any station.
Yeah, that's going
to
be a big
huge.
Hit.
We're out of time for tonight. We'll see you tomorrow. FreeTalkLive.com. Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Flaming Freedom is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 26, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,205, up $10. Silver opened at $17.08, up 13 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $252.71. Today's metal prices are brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. In the news, a new study from the International Physicians for the Prevention of Nuclear War has found that the United States' war on terror has caused more than 1 million deaths in Iraq, Afghanistan, and Pakistan. The report points out that while the U.S.-led multinational force in Iraq, NATO, and other military operations have maintained statistics for American casualties, they have failed to track the number of foreign deaths. The study also says the U.S. government number ignore casualties, injured, or killed, involving enemy combatants and civilians. A new 9/11 Review Commission report examined how well the FBI implemented changes recommended following the September 11th attacks. The report suggests the FBI should expand domestic spying operations to include entire ethnic communities as part of the war on terror. The commission calls for domain awareness or monitoring of racial, ethnic, or religious groups in search of individuals who might become radicalized and commit acts of terror. The report also discusses the FBI using community outreach or infiltration of communities suspected of terrorism. Both the Democrats and Republicans are proposing legislative solutions to the Federal Communications Commission's recent net neutrality measures. Republicans have introduced legislation to codify the FCC's order, including prohibitions on Internet service providers from blocking, slowing, or selling priority delivery of content to consumers. Leading Democrats have expressed an interest in working with Republicans to pass a bill that establishes net neutrality as law. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Looking to promote your business or cause to tens of thousands of loyal listeners? Well, for a limited time only, the Liberty Beat is offering you the chance to save big while spreading your message. It's simple. Just sign up for 3 months of advertising and get your fourth month free. Don't miss out on this unique opportunity. Just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise and use coupon code GCN in the Describe Your Company section. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 26, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. At the request of Iraq, the United States on Wednesday began airstrikes into Crete. CBS News reports the measure is taken in support of a stalled Iraqi ground offensive to retake the city from Islamic State of Iraq and Syria fighters. CBS News calls the bombing a significant expansion of the U.S. military role in Iraq. The newly proposed California Electronic Communications Privacy Act would require warrants for the use of Stingray cell phone surveillance, also known as cell site simulators. The California state bill was approved by the Senate Public Safety Committee on Tuesday. In other Stingray news, Senators Patrick Leahy and Chuck Grassley have sent a new letter to the White House seeking answers on the use of the devices, which can indiscriminately gather cell phone data. The senators said the Department of Justice's failure to answer questions has heightened their concerns. A new bill has been introduced, which would create a government-certified label for food that is not genetically engineered. Representative Mike Pompeo said the label would be voluntary for companies who want to advertise their food as GE-free. The bill would put authority for certification under the Agriculture Department. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at MyMagicMud.com. Support also comes from the Conscious Resistance Network. Videos, news reports, and articles from a spiritual anarchist perspective. Experience the Conscious Resistance at theconsciousresistance.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 26, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
From Betty Davis's first role as a piece of chocolate cake in the 1931 film Palmy Days to the discovery of Niagara Falls in 1996, The Onion looks back at this week in history. On May 16, 1929, the first Academy Awards were handed out in categories such as Greatest Achievement in Blackface, Best Catholic Whipping Scene, and Most Gorgeous Gams on Abroad. The highlight of the night occurred when Wings won the award for Best Picture without a single Dago, Tar Baby, or Wetback. And on May 15, 1940, the first McDonald's opened in San Bernardino, California, back when a young Grimace was just working as a cashier. And that